Welcome to it, you beauties. Thank you so much for dialing it in. It's your midweek feel-good injection. We got the energy that you need. And we're going to delve into all things culinary hotline because it is a Wednesday morning and we're here to embrace that. So thank you so much for being here and welcome to it. It's going to be a fun one. We've got the beautiful Lamise Abrahams in studio. She's going to be sharing some of her Eid dessert recipe secrets, and she's got some absolute pearlers from mango and passion fruit Charlotte to hazelnut and chocolate dessert cups. They look amazing. And we'll give you a few more, I think, arrows in your quiver when it comes to laying out the most exquisite spread. Just look at that. Then what's a morning routine without the body getting its put through its paces? We got you moving this morning. I'm going to be put through my paces, undoubtedly, with a step class hosted by choreographer Courtney Smith. For everyone at home, it is accessible, so you can join in. Please do, in fact. And then finally, on the entertainment stage, we've got the young and uber-talented Milan, ready to showcase his latest single, Breathe. And that's all we want you to do this morning is just breathe. And someone needs a little bit of help getting out of the gates today, and maybe just a little bit of influence when it comes to choosing her outfit, is ready to embrace the day and embrace you as well. Good morning, Zoe.
Oh, good morning, G-Man. Yes, it is a brand new day. For some people, it's a fake Monday. I am myself, if you're going back to work, back to school. But we are very excited. And today, I actually need to think about this because today is not Tuesday. It is, in fact, Wednesday. But usually on a Tuesday, it's all about asking you to help me choose the correct outfit. And it is the month of April, so we want to play and experiment with some color and deep colors at that. We also have Eid celebrations coming up, so this is the perfect modest wear outfit inspiration. So first up, you get to choose between this beautiful satin dress. It's got some button detail and a cute little waist belt to cinch in and just emphasize your beautiful waist. And then we have a two-piece option as option two. We also have this satin long line shirt and wide leg pants option, going more for a traditional look, and that will also be fabulous if you're going to an Eid feast or perhaps a glamorous dinner party. So these are the two options for you to go and vote for. Now, it might be Wednesday, but we are still calling it Tuesday because you're choosing the outfit for me to wear. Are we going to go for option one or option two? The choice is yours.
Yes, so seeing as we've mentioned the word feast about 100 times already this morning, maybe that's where we should jump off today. We're putting it to you guys this morning. What are you and your family making for Eid this year? Inspire us, blow our minds. We want pictures, we want voice notes, we want to hear how excited you are to tell us about your Eid traditions. You can share those voice notes with us really easily. 063-408-8863. That's the WhatsApp line to chat about anything that you see on the show that really sparks your interest. But we want to hear from you this morning. You can also hit us up on all of our social media platforms. What are you going to be whipping up for Eid this year? We'd love to hear from you. Likewise, we're going to give you a couple of talking points yourself this morning as we delve into those sporting and news headlines. Then we're going to have a whole lot of fun. Stick around, but let's get into the news.
Let's start off with national headlines. Law enforcement officers issued some 900,000 fines over the Easter weekend after stopping and checking thousands of vehicles since the start of the Easter holidays. More than 1,000 motorists and road users were arrested since last Thursday. The Road Traffic Management Corporation said some 900 vehicles were impounded during law enforcement operations held in all nine provinces. The corporation said the arrests were related to various offences such as drunk driving, falsified driving documentation, reckless driving and vehicles overloaded with goods and passengers. And staying with our local news, the Minister of Health, Joe Pashla, says the process of recovering the remains of 33 of the 45 victims of the accident in which a bus from Botswana careered off a bridge in Limpopo will take a long time. Pashla said there were several delays in identifying the deceased. Pashla and Limpopo's MEC for Health, Poppy Ramatuba, yesterday visited the only survivor of the disaster, an 8-year-old girl. She's making good progress and is expected to be discharged from hospital today. We now move to news beyond our own borders. An international tourist was reportedly fatally injured yesterday when an elephant flipped a safari vehicle in the Kafue National Park in Zambia. Two other tourists were injured and were rushed to hospital in the capital, Lusaka. A detailed statement is awaited from the Kafue National Park. Elephants are able to run at a speed of up to 40 kilometers an hour, and many people misjudge the threat they pose because of their size. Founded in the 1920s and formally established as a national park in the 1950s, Zambia's Kafue National Park is one of the largest game reserves in Africa. And Polish Prime Minister Donald Tusk has warned that Europe is in a pre-war era and Ukraine must not be defeated by Russia for the good of the entire continent. Tusk said war was no longer a concept from the past and added, I quote, it's real, and it started over 2 years ago, end of quote. Now, his comments came after Russia had launched a massive attack on Ukraine's energy system last Thursday. Russian President Vladimir Putin said earlier the idea that his country would attack Poland, the Baltic states and the Czech Republic was complete nonsense. And bringing it back home, the South African Foundation for the Conservation of Coastal Birds, known as SANCOB, in Gqeberha, has achieved international certification from the Global Humane Conservation Programme, a significant milestone in its mission to protect seabird populations. Global Humane, renowned as its world's largest certifier of animal welfare practices, bestowed this honour after SANCOB passed a rigorous independent assessment. Dr. Robin Gunzert, Global Humane's president, praised SANCOB for its exceptional animal care, particularly its efforts in reversing the decline of endangered species such as the African penguin. SANCOB's Gqeberha Center manager, Carl Haveman, said they were immensely proud to have met Global Humane's high standards and would continue to provide the highest quality care to their seabird patients. Well, on that very positive note, that's where I leave those headlines. Let's take a first look at your sport.
Thank you so much, Zoe. It's with mixed feelings that we start our sports bulletin this morning. Fans of rugby will understand why. Sam Whitelock, the most capped player in All Blacks history, is set to retire from professional rugby at the conclusion of his current club season in France. The 35-year-old Lock has made 153 appearances for New Zealand, securing two Rugby World Cup titles during his illustrious career along the way, following New Zealand's narrow defeat at the hands of the Springbok in that World Cup final last year. Whitelock joined Pau in France's top 14 on a two-year contract, and his retirement announcement now dispels any speculation about a potential return to test rugby this year amid some rumours that new All Blacks head coach Scotty Robinson had in fact approached him. Now we turn to cricket. He's out as well. England all-rounder Ben Stokes has now made the decision to withdraw himself from the consideration even for this summer's T20 World Cup to prioritise his fitness. Now, following knee surgery during the winter, Stokes only bowled five overs in the recent five-test series in India. The 32-year-old, who also served as England's test captain, had previously opted out of the IPL, which commenced last month. Now, England, the defending champions, will compete in the T20 World Cup, scheduled to take place in the West Indies and then the United States in June. Now, let's stay with some cricketing news, but the action very much still happening on the field. And yesterday, Quinton de Kock's impressive half-century and Mayank Yadav's outstanding bowling performance propelled the Lucknow Super Giants to a commanding 28-run victory over the Royal Challengers Bangalore. It was in their IPL League encounter at the M. Chinnaswamy Stadium. So opting to bat first after winning the toss, Lucknow's Super Giants, they posted a formidable total of 181 for 5. In response, the Royal Challengers, they struggled to get out of the gates. They were bowled out for 153 ultimately in just under 20 overs, falling short obviously of that target. Now, golfing fans can get excited. The big one has arrived. The 2024 Masters Tournament is set to commence at the famed Augusta National from the 11th of this month to the 15th of April. Now, featuring a select group of LIV Golf members as well, vying for the prestigious green jacket, Augusta National, renowned as one of the most iconic and, I think, difficult golf courses worldwide, it's an highly anticipated event, obviously, marking the beginning of the golf major season. Now, among those LIV players, competing, Sergio Garcia, Dustin Johnson, Phil Mickelson, and Brooks Koepka, adding a whole lot more excitement to the tournament. And then even more on top of that, Tiger Woods could break a tournament record by making the cut for the 24th consecutive time in his 26th appearance. Wouldn't that be great? So quite a lot happening on the sporting front, even though it is the midweek, and we'll touch on those headlines again in about an hour or so. Let's see what today has in store weather-wise.
Thank you, Graham. And the SA Weather Service has not issued any severe weather alerts for today, although scattered showers and thunderstorms are anticipated in various regions, accompanied by cool to warm temperatures across most parts of South Africa. Meanwhile, Johannesburg Water anticipated completing repairs at the Honeydew Reservoir by early this morning. The reservoir had been experiencing capacity issues, causing water shortages for residents in Randburg and nearby areas during the Easter weekend. Johannesburg Water assured residents of continued support, including alternative water supply through mobile water tanks until normal supply is restored. Well, that is your weather update. If you would love to share your sunrise view with us, please do so on our WhatsApp line at 063-408-8863. Let's take a first look at your temperatures for today.
Below 30 in Upington, officially the seasons have changed. Now, all I'm dying to really know this morning, having this incredible human being stood right beside me, Milan, welcome back, my friend. All I want to know is, what were you thinking in that moment right there?
Thank you. Let's look pretty on camera.
And you nailed it. He's here to do what he does best. That's pose amongst trees. No, that's singing just for you. And yes, a little bit for us this morning. We're going to get into the singer-songwriter's journey and where he has been and what he's been up to. And then we're going to get moving. We're going to get your body moving and up and get those cobwebs out of the system with a bit of a step class. Have a little bit of fun with us. We get moving after this.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back. It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show Espresso on S3. And joining us right now is Milan. He's a vibrant singer and songwriter who has released a brand new single titled Breathe. And we have a little sneak peek just for you.
Except for love, love, love. Write it all in paradise. Take the truth and bring the light. We will love.
Oh, it's got a feel-good feel to it, and I feel like it's only right we give a feel-good welcome to Milan. Welcome back to Espresso.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
We even got the crowd to cheer for you, a live studio audience.
I love it. I love it, yeah. Thank you so much.
I love it when we have local musicians with their local music videos, and I have to ask you, firstly, how does it feel seeing yourself on the screen? Is it something you've gotten used to?
Feels like I was built for this, I'm happy seeing it there.
And the second thing is always, I try and identify the location that music video was shot at. Am I correct in guessing around Lion's Head?
Oh, no, but you have two more guesses.
Oh, goodness, no, then I'm lost. Is it Constantia Forest or the Tukai Forest?
Ooh, a little further afield, I'll give you a hint. It's in the Garden Route.
Ooh, okay, no, I will not. Is it George?
Oh, close enough. It's at a George Dam, actually, that particular one.
Okay.
The secret part of the forest, maybe if you're lucky, I'll take you there one day.
Oh, listen, I love the visuals, of course. The song is energetic.
Thank you.
Tell me more about this single.
Yeah, so Breathe came about one night very spontaneously, and it was almost a message to remember to relax. Mm. And, you know, our modern times can be very stressful, and we can get so worked up into things when we actually should remember to take a step back, look around, breathe, exactly.
And it's something so basic that I think we forget to do it because we're so caught up in our everyday life. When have been those moments for you where you've actually had to remind yourself to just breathe?
I love it. I put quite an important priority on mindfulness, spirituality. So almost every morning I'll remind myself, listen, let's start this day off right.
Okay.
You know, let's take a few deep breaths. What are we grateful for? What do we want to achieve today? And yeah, so quite often there was a time it wasn't like that.
Okay.
And it was very stressful, but I can recommend that mindfulness and spirituality, whatever it is, to anybody. So.
Definitely, definitely. When we talk about, you know, the inspiration behind music, you now kind of told us the inspiration behind Breathe and the meaning of the song. Your music has got a really great feel-good beat to it. Is that how you would explain your sound or describe it?
Yeah, I would say it is uplifting and inspiring by nature, by design, because I want... As a human, we all have a limited amount of years on the planet, and I want to spend my years uplifting people. And my teacher in grade 3, it would always say, work smart, not hard.
Okay.
So I thought, how could I uplift as many people as possible in the easiest way, in the shortest way? And that's by putting it into music and getting this music on the TV, on the radio, in stadiums, festivals, you name it. And I can give that little... Doesn't have to be a lot, 3 minutes in a day, that's all I ask, and you listen and you can maybe smile at the car next to you. That's my job done.
And if everyone's happier, the world becomes a better place.
Oof.
Definitely.
Sorry.
Now, you had a really incredible opportunity opening for Karan Zoid.
Yes.
What was that moment like for you?
It was quite full circle, you know, I mean, growing up, obviously, so I come from an Afrikaans family, and to hear her songs when I'm young, to kind of grow up and go, oh, no ways, Karan, you know, we on in five type thing, and to shake the hands and be a contemporary was really quite a milestone, I'd say. And you have that feeling of, wow, maybe, you know, God is smiling on me for this
yes.
one. And thank you. And it's going really well. So, yeah, more of those.
More
please.
Of those.
More of those.
Which other local artists would you love to open for, collaborate with, put it into the universe? You never know who might be Ooh. Listening right now.
Jeremy Loops.
Ah.
The Deep South Royalty, I'll open for you. Sean Koch, I'll open for you. Matthew Moll, I'll open for you.
Okay, I see the way you are going. Okay. Now, I know you also a few years ago did your Sunshine tour.
Yeah.
Can we see any other tours in the pipeline?
They will definitely, although it would be a bit of a overseas tour to share some of the South African light and magic, you know, in the dark, gloomy UK.
Okay.
Though a local tour, I'll definitely be planning to go perhaps for a Park Life Festival in Johannesburg, Gauteng side, and maybe a few other shows there in Gauteng. People have been asking, so
okay. Well, there you have it. If you ask, he delivers, ladies and gentlemen. Milan, on your Feel Good Breakfast show. He's not going anywhere because he's our guest performer for today, so stay tuned to hear him perform.
And why would he go anywhere when he has this level of entertainment to take in this morning? We're going to have a little bit of fun this morning, and we're going to get moving with the Step Lab, where we fuse the energy of old school hip-hop and R&B with some dynamic dance movements. It's the best way to motivate yourself to get up and moving. And we're joined by the dynamic owner of the Step Lab himself, Courtney Smith, with his lovely dance assistants. I will ask you to introduce the ladies. Before we get going, buddy, thank you so much for being here. I discovered through my own journey, as terrible as I am when it comes to musicality and dancing, there is no better tool to get yourself motivated to get up, get moving, to burn an insane amount of calories, and you don't even realize you're doing it because you're having so much fun. I'm getting nods at the background. So, buddy, talk me through what you do very quickly at the Step Lab. Why is this so effective?
Me dancing, first of all, that already gets a proper workout going.
For
with
sure.
This, in a less amount of time, surprisingly. So, like, the way I feel after 10 minutes of this is the way I would feel after an hour and a half, 2 hours of normal.
Of just going through your paces?
Yeah, just dancing. So, yeah, upper body strength, you're working on your coordination, burning loads and loads of fat. So,
for sure.
You'll feel it.
And it's the mental energy of getting the movements right, the choreography, he says, with some hope that he is actually going to get it right. No, thank you so much for being here. Let's rock and roll. And I like the fact that we can vary this for varying degrees of fitness and ability. So let's jump right in. And, of course, you guys at home, you are expected to do this with us. If you can film it, please do it. Get the ring light out and let's get going. Right, Billy, let's rock and roll.
So I'm
going
to start you with a basic combination. Yeah. Obviously, we'll get grooving because obviously we have that introduction. We don't just want to immediately start.
Sure.
While the music's playing at the back slowly, so I don't want you to obviously, you need to get used to the step
first. Play such funky tunes if you want people just to ease into it, man, you know?
Okay, so we're going to start with the right foot onto the step first. So right foot on, tap your knee, back, down, up, tap your knee, back, down. That's your first count of four. So can I see you get into that? So we'll go and one, back, down. And two, back, down. Now we try and pick up that pace because we obviously need to get the workout. So
yeah,
six, seven, and a one, down, two, and three, down, four. Nice. Okay, so from there we're going into a knee lift. So you're lifting the knee. Up, down, step, and up, down, step. Up, down, step, and up, down, step. So it's fine if it changes feet. It's just going to mess up the next combination. So start, right, back, down. Start, right, back, swap. And we go, down, down, and we go, down. Lift your knee up, down, down, knee up, down,
swap,
down.
Cool.
Yeah? We're gonna get there.
Okay.
And again, we go five from the top and seven, eight. We go one, two, three, four, and up, up, and again, up. Up, nice. So you have your first combination. So now we get into it and used to it. We continue with that only. Five and a six and a five. Six, seven, eight. We go up, down, swap, up, down, and up, and again, up. Lovely stuff. Now we go into something called the ankle tap or the heel tap.
All right.
So we're just going to go tap to the side, down, So you'll notice that just like Zumba classes, the steps are very repetitive. It's not meant to turn into a full dance routine.
It's not choreography.
Yeah.
It's movement, yeah.
You have to somehow choreograph to a certain extent so that you're kind of innovative with the movements and they don't look the same as an aerobics step class.
Keep the mind going, yeah, for sure.
Because I mean, everybody is offering the aerobic step classes. It's just at the moment, no one is doing.
Tapping into that musicality, yeah. For sure, yeah.
So we go again slowly, just the taps. Tap, down, down, and tap. So we do this four times. Tap, down, down, and tap, down, down. Now you have four combinations of four. Here we go from the top. 5, 6, 7, 8. And to the side, to the side, to the side, to the side. Knee lift and down, lift and down, lift and down, lift angle tap. We go one, swap and two, swap and three, swap and four. You getting there again.
There we go, there we go. Easy.
How's it feeling? It.
I love that.
How's the body feeling? Are you building up a slight bit of sweat?
You can feel it. I can feel I'm breathless, man. I think there's something about the mental energy required to kind of focus on that, then let it go and just actually do it and jump into it. You can feel it, man.
So the way the classes are done is that you would do this throughout an entire song. So the difficulty level's all going to depend on the music that you're playing. The quicker the music, the quicker the step.
Completely.
Yeah?
You know what I love about this is we get so much inspiration from music just as a basis point. It changes our mood. It gets us moving without us even noticing we're moving. If you can combine that with a focused, practiced routine like this, absolutely amazing. Cool. Courtney, I love this. Sam, that was a nice little warm-up for round two. We're going to be delving into more of what the Step Lab do, an incredible fusion of some unbelievable music. Yep, you gotta have the playlist down and getting your body moving. So you can start warming up. We'll be moving again after this. Well done, nice.
Quickest of breaks while Graham is doing a bit of a warm up. When we get back, it's time to reveal the winning outfit. If you have not voted for today's outfit that I get to wear, head on over to Expresso's social media pages. Vote for option one, the dress, or option two, the two-piece. And then when we get back, it's round two of the suits, in fact, the step class. So don't go anywhere, we'll be right back.
It's my feel-good show. Oh, welcome back, you beauties. Yep, we're getting changed literally every 30 seconds on the show, and we love it, especially when the results are as spectacular as they're going to be in just a moment. I think over the past few years, Modest Wear has gained a prominence in the fashion industry, and our very own Zoe Brown, of course, asked you to help her choose between two Modest-inspired looks, both exquisite. I think option one was the belted Mandarin satin dress, featuring a very standout print and then a nice button detail and the belt to go with it. And then option two was a sequin satin long-lined shirt, and that was paired with matching wide-leg pants. Two fantastic looks. Let's see where you were leaning towards. Teresa's saying option one will look stunning on the ever-gorgeous Zoe. I agree with you. I think she'll look great in that. Nomti saying definitely one will do. Ashanti saying styled by Woolies, one printed Mandarin dress, please. Now, you can't order them from us, eh? You've got to go to the Woolies app. Willida say, I'm going to go with outfit one. I like the fact that she wasn't decided. She was thinking about it still, even while she was writing that comment. Kohli saying, good morning, Zoe. Option one for you, my dear. Have a wonderful day. Okay, that was just for Zoe, not for the rest of us. Zelda Hennessy say, I'm going with option one, stunning dress. Good morning. Good morning. Right back at you. I think the people have spoken. Some exquisite, exquisite options, but option one has won out. And our gorgeous Zoe Brown steps in. That is
wearing the dress. Oh, I love a good dress. So thank you for voting for option one. It is elegant. It is chic. I love these tones. So yes, it's a winner for me.
And there's a lot going on with that print. Hey, it's beautiful.
Thank you.
I love the fact that it's not too blocked. It's amazing. Absolutely beautiful. Elegant and chic. And I think you guys have nailed it this morning. So give yourselves a little mini round of applause. Well done. You can shop these standout, modest, inspired looks at Woolworths in-store, online, or using their incredible app. In fact, get a whole lot more inspiration on that spot. But absolutely amazing.
Thank you very much. Ready for the day.
Well, we promised you a little bit more fun. Thanks to the Step Lab, and Courtney has stuck around to take us through a few more movements in their dance-inspired fitness routine. This is where hip-hop gets a little bit of a fitness makeover. And, of course, the two work beautifully together. So what have you got planned for us for our little second round here?
Now okay, so this
kind
one,
of warmed up.
This one's a little bit more. So I would say what we did in the beginning is just for you to get a feel. We'll show you what an entire set would look like. And this set we would do then over the entire song. So that is when you really start to feel build on the endurance and all of that.
You feel the burn.
Yeah.
Just say it, man. You feel the burn.
We'll show you the entire set, and then we'll work with you to get as close as possible to the end.
Yeah, brilliant, man. I love that.
Cool. So once we... Yeah, music's a little bit quicker. So this is what I spoke about earlier, where the tempo picks up. So if you watch just for the first section, I don't want you to,
to pull a brain
to be
muscle.
Overwhelmed. Yeah. So we're five, six, seven, eight.
Not playing. Love it, you're crossing
the table.
Brain as well. Wow.
Now we go single. Double time. Single.
Purpose, I love it.
Double time. Then we go for ankle taps. And around.
The sound of a footfall. I absolutely love it.
Ankle tap again. And last one over the table. Five, six, seven, eight.
Yo.
Yeah? So that we would repeat.
Wow. You have confidence, my friend. You have confidence.
Okay.
Great, great confidence. I absolutely love that. And it is, it's kind of basic movements, but it's stuff just taken a level higher, a step further. Where do we begin?
Okay, so we're going to start with, well, we literally just made up the name, over the table.
Over the table,
yeah.
I like it.
So right foot steps.
That is very hip-hop, hey?
Your left foot goes behind and over.
Okay.
And tap before you step back onto the step. There we go, onto the step, off the step, tap. And again, on, over.
On, over.
And tap, last one, behind.
On, over.
And tap. There we go. Now we're going around the table. So we step onto the step, to the back, and all the way around. and we just breathe lightly to tap and enjoy the music. Keep the left leg on and around, two, three, and tap again, tap, 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 and tap. Can we just do that for now?
Okay.
Yeah, so we go over, right, left behind, right foot, tap, tap. Left, left, right behind, and tap, and repeat. Oh. And again. Now we go around the table, step, and around, and around, and around, and relax, and tap, and tap, seven, tap. And eight, and again, two, three, four, tap, and tap, and tap, and tap. So you feel comfortable with the way that you're tapping, and you're still getting to know the step, so
cool.
Take your time, yeah?
Yeah, no, I love it, man. I love the fact that you're balancing the physical and the mental kind of movement and understanding as well. It just ramps up the amount. I would imagine the amount of energy you're burning in your brain, never mind just your body.
Your coordination is tested quite a bit. Okay, last time. So we go over, six, seven, slowly. One, and two, and three, tap. Four, and five, six, and again. Right foot, there we go. Left foot, left. Now we go around, right foot on and around. And relax, seven and turn. And tap and tap and tap and tap.
Okay,
do you want to take it up a notch?
Yeah, let's do one more, come on, man. You know there are people at home going, come on, let's just step it up a gear, come on.
So single, we're going to go right foot up and left, down, down, swap. Up, right, down, swap. Left, up, down, swap, right, up. Now we go double, so one, up, 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 change, and two, up, 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 change, and single, 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 single. Now double, double, and again double. Lovely stuff. Let's try just a single and a double.
We will do that as we combine these little movements together. It's amazing. I'm sweating. I'm out of breath. I've done it at about 5% of where you could take this. If you fully invest yourself in the movement, the music will take you to another level. There is something so special about combining something that inspires us in this way with something that gets us moving so functionally, absolutely amazing. Cool. Right, let's work it, my friend, let's work it. Hopefully this has got you up and moving, and yes, burning the calories we're about to take in.
Okay, so we go single, single, up and swap, single, up and swap, single, up and swap, single, double time, we go double, up, 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 change, and up, 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 singles, one, up, change, two, up, nice, and
on.
Three, and four, and we go now, double.
You've created two, a monster.
And double, single, push it, tingle, one, two.
Nice.
Still push it.
Absolutely brilliant, you guys.
G-Man has the moves and he proved it. Well, listen, we are taking the quickest of breaks because Lamise Adams is here, Abrams is here, and she is so excited. I'm so excited because when it comes to her Instagram account, Just Baked, there's always the sweetest of sweet treats. And I'm so excited that you're sharing some of your Eid dessert recipes with us. So we are very excited for that. And then we will see you in just a bit with our own little bit of a game of Guess the Meal. So we'll be right back.
Are you auditioning and getting ready for Tropica Island of Treasure? Well, don't let joint and muscular pain hold you back. Deep Eat is your go-to warm-up solution and SA's number one choice.
Oh, yes, and here's an extra incentive. The top seven contestants heading to the island will each receive 10,000 Rand from Deep Eat. And remember, you can upload your audition with the hashtag Deep Eat and the hashtag Tropica and tag My Tropica.
Who knows, you could be competing in Zanzibar.
Yeah, it's time to reach your full potential.
Get Deep Eat and conquer the island.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome. Welcome to the kitchen this very fine Wednesday. The phone lines are open, which must mean it's a culinary hotline bling!
Ting, ting,
that was me. That was me. I got tongue-tied because I just got the smell of this cake. It's a culinary hotline bling!
Ting, ting, ting.
Now, before I get too distracted by this amazing cake, let me tell you, if you're looking for eatspiration, this is the place. Lamise Abrams is in the kitchen this morning.
Good morning, Claire.
I'm going to block you on social media.
Why?
I'm trying to lose weight, but your social media account, oh my goodness,
yes,
Instagram.
Why I can't lose weight.
No, oh, your Instagram is filled with the most amazing desserts, and it is such a treat every time we get you in the kitchen, especially now, because people are looking for that inspiration.
Yeah.
So you're going to be taking
us around the corner.
Literally. Yeah. And you're going to be taking us through three amazing desserts this morning. Oh, I'm so tempted, South Africa. I haven't had sugar in, like, I can't tell you how long. And the smell of this is just, I'm going to actually have some sugar this morning. Having it. If you have any questions, or if you want to let us know what you're doing this eat, the dish that is in front of me, that has got a combination of some of my most nostalgic ingredients and most... I can't explain to you how much I love mango.
A mango and passion fruit Charlotte.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, let's start cooking, because the very first question, what is a Charlotte?
So a Charlotte is a French mold cake.
Mm-hmm.
So it basically comprises of ladyfingers, which you can make yourself. But if you don't have time, the boudoir biscuits work perfectly fine. Because they're just as light and airy, and they just work perfectly with the Charlotte as well.
It does. Okay, so
we need to save time.
We do need to save time. So let's get cracking.
Yes.
I'm still trying to find out there. Can you see what's happening inside the cake? Let me just tip it down a little bit for you. There we go.
We're still going to decorate it.
It's going to get a lot fancier?
Yes.
There we go, that's the word fancier. Ooh, you see. Okay, here we go. So we're going to start off with the filling.
Okay, first we're going to do our boudoir biscuits.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to leave that to you.
Yes.
So what you can do, you need a spring foam tin. Mm-hmm. Place it on your serving dish, whatever you want to, you know, present your dish on. And then we're going to take our boudoir biscuits.
I like how you said if you have time, you can make these. I have never.
Never. They're very easy.
Actually, no, I lie. In chef school, first year, we made them. And I think that was the lesson that we learned that day was just buy it. It is a lot of fun to make, but buying it is so much easier.
Yeah.
And it's so nostalgic. We actually had, I think it was Zoe in the kitchen earlier saying, it reminds her
of her childhood.
Of her childhood. There we go.
Yeah,
so
I think all the moms gave the kids these when they were little.
Okay, so is that what I'm doing? I nearly put into it. Okay, so what I'm doing. So all I'm doing is I'm stacking
them. I was looking for the knife, but all you do is just cut the tip, just so that it's nice and straight, because the edges are rounded.
Okay.
So what we'll do is we'll just cut the tip and then we'll just place them
all
around the edge. Yes, I've already trimmed
them. Okay,
we've
already trimmed them. And so what's essentially holding it up right now? Nothing. It's the flat surface. They're just balancing.
They're balancing. That's correct. But once we add our filling, they will be stable.
Okay, so at home, what you're going to do again, just to get that balance, you're going to just slice the last little bit off to give you a firm base so it can stand up straight. That's all you're doing. So we're good. Okay.
Okay.
I was supposed to be
doing
this.
So you're
going to
do that.
So
okay. You do your job, and then we're basically going to add some whipped cream to cream cheese, mascarpone, and icing sugar.
So
that's going to be our filling.
I like.
So it's a nice creamy texture. So it's almost like a tiramisu because it has the mascarpone.
It's getting
tiramisu. But it also has the.
But we're not baking it. We're not baking it.
That's
what I love
baking.
About this. Just like a tiramisu, we don't bake it.
No.
Which is, to be honest with you, I love sweet things. I think I've made that very obvious.
Yes.
I'm not the biggest baker. When I do bake, I like recipes that are simple and come together pretty easily.
Yes.
And that's a lot. That's your. What is your philosophy? Because I get that energy a lot from your bakers.
Yeah, no, I like to make things easy, you know, simple and easy, because I love when people present beautiful things and I love how they recreate my recipes, and it brings me so much joy. And making things easier is just, you know, a bonus, because then everyone can do it.
Right, I agree. Like this recipe. Okay, so now I'm going to go and get my knife quickly, because I need the knife. Stay.
Okay, so I'm just going to whip this.
Okay. So I would definitely recommend using a little serrated knife at home, because it's going to make your life so much easier. They've given me a chef knife, but let's see what happens. Whoa! Okay, so once we get all of these to the side, and we fill it.
Mm-hmm.
Because we're not baking it, and because we're using a lot of dairy, is this a dessert you'd say it's best made ahead of time? And how far ahead of time?
That's why I also chose this dessert, because you could make it 2 days in advance.
Okay.
Yeah, so, you know, there's no stress of preparing it the day before Eid, so you have more time to focus on food. you know, because that's huge for us. We like to spend time, more time on our food.
And I've also noticed the amount of effort that goes into the decor on the day. There's a lot of effort. So if you're busy with
And you know you want to do your whole table setting and your flowers, so.
There we go.
This will help you save some time.
Do you do that as well at home? Is that your job?
Yeah, it is.
You're busy then on the day.
Yeah.
Guys.
No, but my mom cooks, so at least I don't have to cook.
We will bring this together once we add the filling. Okay, so the filling's looking good, and then when do we start adding all our flavors?
We add a little bit of passion fruit just to give it some extra flavor. Mm-hmm. Okay. And then...
And does the mango go on top?
That's right, the mango's going to go on top, so...
Perfect. Okay, so do we even attempt to put this in here? Let's try.
Yeah, we
can. Let's see. Okay, so...
No, but first we're going to add a layer of biscuits
to
at the bottom as well. That's right. As our base.
You could even make mini ones, right?
Oh my goodness, that is so cute.
I think the little mini chiffons would be like, would be really cute.
Oh, they're gorgeous. Okay.
Guys, I'm glad, you know what?
These boudoir biscuits are not behaving today.
I couldn't get the soldiers to stand up straight. It's not just me. You know what? This is where we fast forward and we go. Here's one. Okay. Yes.
Okay.
So here's one where we've got our base, biscuit base, and the biscuits inside, and we've added the filling to it.
Yeah.
And this goes to the fridge, and we decorate just before serving. So, do we still have time to let Lamise decorate this beautiful cake? We do. Here we go. Okay, Lamise, it's all
mango.
You. This is not me. I don't want to do this because I want to see how these beautiful creations come together.
Okay. So we just add the pulp of the some Granadella pulp on top. Let's just give it some nice texture with the seeds and some color.
And by the way, if you want this recipe at home, go and check it out at espressoshow.com. And Lamise, your Instagram handle is?
Just Baked.
Just Baked. Go and check it out right now. Favorite, it is so, so good. Meringue's going on the top.
Yes.
Isn't it so nice that you can actually buy meringues now?
It's the best.
I can imagine like having to, I do remember having to
make them from scratch. Yeah, I know. Yeah. But they do taste the best though.
When they're homemade?
Yeah, no,
absolutely,
definitely.
I get it. Yeah. I mean, even though I say I'm not the biggest baker, I did work in pastry section for 2 years.
Okay.
So I appreciate the finer details and amount of effort that goes into presenting a cake. Oh my goodness, it looks so good.
Yep, there you go.
Oh, are you getting a view? Are you seeing that? Is that happening? Oh my goodness.
That. And of course, just to finish it off.
Eid Mubarak. Don't forget to send us all your questions or let us know what you're doing this Eid.
And a nice little bow just for the touch because it's special, a nice gold ribbon.
There we go. So send us your voice to 063-408-8863. Lamise isn't going anywhere. We've got two more delicious recipes coming up on the Culinary Hotline Bling.
Ting, ting, ting.
Well, you know, we love food on your Feel Good Breakfast show, so if you're hungry, then why not play along, because it's time for another round of Guess the Meal. And today is the butter edition, because butter makes everything taste better. Uh-huh. And I'm going to show my contestants, aka Milan, our guest artist for today, and G-Man, a series of mystery dishes that are either served or made with butter, and they'll need to tell me what they think it is. Now, whilst we play, we're also going to snack on some delicious leftover hot cross buns from the weekend with Clover's delicious Buttro butter spread. So, gents, feel free to tuck in.
Thank you.
But this is a competition at the end of the day. So, Milan, we've got screens all around and we are going to show you a blurred out photo. This dish is either made with butter or served with butter and you need to guess.
So basically it can be anything.
It can be anything.
Like just about everything is made with butter, right? Like this feels like a very broad brief. Yeah. But I'm ready for it. Let's do it.
So how about you guys grab some delicious hot cross buns.
Grab yourself.
Well, thank you, Greg.
It was an absolute pleasure.
How about we take a look at our very first image? It's behind you, Milan. What do you think that is? It is blurry. Whoa. If you look in front of you, we've got screens all over.
There's a slightly smaller screen that might be a bit more helpful.
And I have a clue. I sound really cool in French.
I know. You sound Graham.
Honored completely.
Go for it, man. Just say it. Proud.
Croissant.
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 I love it.
Okay, well done. One point each. Let's move over to our next clue and image. So, brown, caramelly coloured rectangles. And your clue is, I need roughly 4 ingredients to bake, but quality butter is the most important.
Graham.
Could be anything.
I'm thinking it's... Shortbread. It's got to be shortbread, hey? Shortbread, is that a...
I don't know. Milan, what do you think?
Toffee.
Oh, this is a smart guy here, so...
Thanks for saying that, man. Thanks, man.
I'm going to go for a fudge, yeah, fudge.
Fudge, when you look at it that far, when I see it in inception mode behind you about 1,000 times...
Okay, so is it shortbread or is it fudge? Let's see.
Shortbread!
Wow. G-Man gets the point. Hey. Sorry, Milan.
That was quite
okay. It did look like fudge. Okay, let's move on to our next round. Round 3, and you have a clue. I'm saucy.
Ooh. Wow.
We know you are, Zoe.
No. The clue to the photo.
I just... I want to say muscles, but that feels like completely off-brief. I don't know, you put some muscle butter in the muscle
sauce. It's so tough. Can we see it again?
Let's see it again.
Hey?
Well, yeah, wow, I mean, I just want to say what he says. I'm going to go for...
saucy.
Butter sauce.
What is in the butter sauce?
Tons of ingredients, Zoe.
Yeah, tons, man. It's a small
don't you think
sport.
I'll say like figs.
Just so, yeah, I'll say snails.
So that is. Let's see what the garlic snails is.
No, we were way off.
Mushrooms
in garlic butter sauce.
I said butter sauce. Wow, that's really half a point.
That was quite a challenge.
Can we get half a point to Milan?
I'm giving
butter sauce.
Two thirds of a point.
So generous.
So what is the score now? Graham 2, Milan 1, and 2/3.
Yeah, 2/3.
I'll take everything.
I'll give you 3/4 even, yeah.
Let's move over to clue number 4. Yellow.
Scrambled eggs.
Your clue is, I'm super popular at the breakfast table.
It's got to be scrambled eggs. Come on, man. Please help yourselves.
Lon, what do you think?
Because we made scrambled eggs, and apparently the only way to make scrambled eggs, according to Jenny Morris and according to Gordon Ramsay, with lots of butter. And then Jenny Morris was like, even more butter at the end, if you can.
Well, I mean, I'm being kind of shoehorned into it, but I believe it is.
You have your own independent question.
Scrambled eggs.
I suppose we are the breakfast salespeople. I think that is kind of our job. That's where we start. That's the one thing.
So are we confirming the score is 3 and 2/3? Okay, let's move over to the next one before we lose track of the score. Your clue for this clue is serve me hot.
Serve me hot? Oh, fat cooks? I don't know. That looks... I'm getting so hungry just looking at
potato,
that.
Potato, I'd have to say, like, baked potato.
Baked potato. I like your style, kid. I like your style.
G-Man?
Is it a fit? I'm going to go with a fit cook. I'm going to go with a fit cook because...
I was going to say that, too.
I dream about fit cook, I think.
Okay, final answer, a baked potato.
Well done. If you win this by 2/3, dude, there's no coming back from that. I'm never going to forgive you, man. I'm never.
Well, that is the score, leading by 2/3. Let's see if we can get Graham more points.
Okay, I just need to get 2/3 of an answer right, and I'm there.
Take a look at that image. It's a bit blurry, I know. But your clue is watch out for your breath.
Watch out for your breath. Oh, there's garlic, definitely.
Yeah, it must be garlic.
But what garlic?
Garlic snails, garlic loaf, garlic bread. Garlic bread!
Garlic bread. Let's see, what is the answer? What is the answer? Yes, it is indeed.
Oh, man, I feel like we had to share garlic a brain bread to get that
right. I can't really. I think we should half-half.
Give him 1/3 and give me 2/3.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah, that's only fair.
I'm going to end up in a draw.
Let's take a look at one more.
So I couldn't quite hear you there, Zoe.
I'm sorry. I'm enjoying my hot cross bun with butter.
Just bread, eh? Come on.
What kind of bread? Is it banana bread?
Sourdough crazy bread. Banana bread feels
Here's
right,
your clue. Hey? You need an easy spreading butter like clover butter or you'll break me.
I would then go with the banana bread, a softer bread, a Madeira cake.
Wow, you know your bread, Graham.
I've been intermittent fasting for a while now, but I have a special focus on my food.
Yeah. Okay, let's see. Oh. I'm going to go for...
Gingerbread.
Just flipping banana bread.
Okay.
Let's see, what is the answer? And the answer is just sliced
bread.
And the answer, we'll give it to you.
Just as awesome as you, my friend. That's the new baseline definition.
Takes on to no one.
Sliced bread is just as good as this guy.
Oh, these two bread. Bread bros.
They want to just have their bread buttered on both sides.
But butter really does make everything taste better. And we'd love to hear from you. What is your favorite meal or tasty treat to add that little bit of extra butter to? You can connect with us online and let us know. Oh, well, G-Man.
So apparently you can have butter with everything. You should actually have butter with absolutely everything. Oh, love it.
I
love another one, please, Mommy. With bacio and lots of jack.
Another sandwich.
Clover Batro. Spread the dairy goodness.
Made with love by Clover.
Oh, made with love, indeed. Likewise, the rest of the show, lots of love coming at you. Small matter of some celebs going to a certain island to play for $1 million. We're going to introduce you to one of our powerhouse celebrities going to Tropica Island of Trela. Nkobile is going to be put through her paces and also put you through yours, potentially, as a partner.
And we have Lamise. She is joining Chef Clem for the Culinary Hotline, and it's all about desserts for Eid. Ooh. Don't go anywhere. She's got another delicious recipe to share with us.
Oh, you can make my day.
Stand a chance to win your share of 40,000 Rand worth of prizes with the exceptional plush range of household cleaning, leather and shoe care products.
Oh yeah, now to enter, purchase any of the plush ranges, take a photo of you using the products and WhatsApp the picture to 069-201-5794.
And with up to 30% off plush products at major retailers this Easter, what are you waiting for? Welcome back, you beauties. We're going to continue our Eid celebrations, celebrating what's going to be on the table with our culinary hotline in just a moment so you can get those conundrums ready. But right now, we've got the official duties to get through some news and sporting headlines.
Thank you, G-Man. Well, let's start off with your national news. The Pretoria High Court has ruled that there are no legal grounds preventing law enforcement officers from carrying out their statutory duties. Judge Suley Porterell said this yesterday in her ruling on the Speaker of the National Assembly, Nosisiwe Mapisa Nqakula's application for an urgent interdict against her arrest. Porterell dismissed the application with costs, another urgent application by the Speaker for a permanent interdict against her arrest will be heard on Tuesday. Mapisa Nqakula is suspected of corruption and money laundering during her tenure as Minister of Defence. Staying with our local news, law enforcement officers issued some 900,000 fines over the Easter weekend after stopping and checking thousands of vehicles since the start of the Easter holidays. More than 1,000 motorists and road users were arrested since last Thursday. The Road Traffic Management Corporation says some 900 vehicles were impounded during law enforcement operations held in all nine provinces. The corporation said the arrests were related to various offences such as drunk driving, falsified driving documentation, reckless driving and vehicles overloaded with goods and passengers. We move to news abroad. Israel faces growing international pressure over an airstrike which killed seven aid workers of the charity World Central Kitchen in Gaza. Nationals of the UK, Poland, Australia, Canada and the US died in the attack. Humanitarian aid to Gaza is now in doubt as World Central Kitchen, one of the main providers of aid to the Strip, has suspended its operations. UK Prime Minister Rishi Sunak has described the situation in Gaza as increasingly intolerable and demand a thorough and transparent independent investigation into the death of the seven aid workers. An international tourist was reportedly fatally injured yesterday when an elephant flipped a safari vehicle in the Kafue National Park in Zambia. Two other tourists were injured and were rushed to a hospital in the capital, Lusaka. A detailed statement is being awaited from the Kafue National Park. Elephants are able to run at sprint speeds of up to 40 kilometers an hour, and many people misjudge the threat they pose because of their size. Founded in 1920s and formally established as a national park in the 1950s, Zambia's Kafue National Park is one of the largest game reserves in Africa. And Taylor Swift has joined the elite club of the world's wealthiest individuals with the likes of Elon Musk, Jeff Bezos, Mark Zuckerberg and Bill Gates on Forbes' latest rich list. The American pop sensation debuted with a staggering $1.1 billion, joining forces with Sam Altman, the brain behind the AI chatbot ChatGPT, also hitting the billion-dollar mark. Topping the charts was Bernard Arnault and his LVMH empire, boasting a wealth of $233 billion. Forbes' 2024 billionaires lineup has a hit record-breaking 2,781 with a collective wealth of $14.2 trillion. Swift's ascent to this financial stratosphere mirrors her megastar status, accentuated by her Grammy Awards triumph and even her impact on NFL viewership, attributed to her present supporting boyfriend Travis Kelce at football showdowns. Well, that is where I leave those headlines. Let's take another look at your sport.
Well, we try to wrap our heads around that one. Let's give you a sporting conundrum, one that is tinged with emotion, certainly for Sam Whitelock. The most capped All Blacks player in history, in fact, is now set to retire from professional rugby at the conclusion of the current club season in France. So the 35-year-old talisman who plays at lock, of course, has made an incredible 153 appearances for New Zealand, securing two Rugby World Cup titles during his illustrious career as well. And following New Zealand's narrow defeat at the hands of the Boks in that World Cup final last year, Whitelock joining Pau in France's top 14 on a two-year contract, and it seems to be his swan song. His retirement announcement dispels any speculation about a potential return to test rugby this year. That, of course, amid rumours that new All Blacks head coach Scott Robinson had approached him. I think the two probably played together. Then we turn to cricket, and another is out. England's all-rounder Ben Stokes has made the decision to withdraw himself from even consideration for the summer's T20 World Cup to prioritise his fitness. Now, following knee surgery during the winter, and quite a big one, Stokes only bowled just five overs in their recent five test series in India. Not the best outing for the team either. The 32-year-old, who also serves as England's test captain at the moment, had previously opted out of the IPL, which commenced last month, losing out on some big money, I'm sure. Now, England, the defending champions, will compete in the T20 World Cup, scheduled to take place in the beautiful West Indies and the United States in June. Certainly going to miss him. Now let's speak about the cricket that did play out yesterday. Quinton de Kock's impressive half century and then Mayank Yadav's outstanding bowling performance backing that up propelled the Lucknow Super Giants to a commanding 28-run victory over the Royal Challengers Bangalore in their Indian Premier League encounter at the M. Chennaswamy Stadium. So opting to bat first after winning that toss, the Lucknow Super Giants posted a formidable total of 181 for 5. In response, the Challengers Bangalore, they struggled to get going. They were ultimately bowled out for 153 in under 20 overs, obviously falling short of that target. Now, plenty for golfing fans to get excited about as the 2024 Masters Tournament gets set to commence at the famed Augusta National from the 11th of April to the 15th, featuring now a nice select group of LIV Golf members vying for the prestigious green jackets. So Augusta National, renowned as one of the most iconic golf courses worldwide, probably one of the most difficult, hosts the highly anticipated event once again, marking the beginning of the golf major season officially. Now, among those LIV players competing are Sergio Garcia, Dustin Johnson, Phil Mickelson, and Brooks Koepka. The big man now adding excitement to the tournament as well. Tiger Woods could break a tournament record if he makes the cut for the 24th consecutive time, and that would be in his 26th appearance. And the word on the wire is he's looking pretty good. So we'll certainly watch that space. Likewise, we'll keep an eye on the roads. I know a lot of people heading back to work today amidst all of the public holidays and extended leave. Let's get you there safely.
Thank you, Graham. Let's start off with traffic in Centurion, Johannesburg. There's been a multi-vehicle accident on the N1 southbound. It's after the ramp from Old Johannesburg Road that right lane is closed and it's causing heavy delays. And in Midrand, Johannesburg, there's been an accident. It's on the R562 Summit Road at Brittle Park. Avoid the affected area and please exercise caution while driving. That's your traffic. Let's take a another look at your weather. And residents and visitors in Cape Town are urged to maintain their water-wise habits as the Western Cape government notes a consistent rise in water demand driven by population growth and economic expansion. This surge, coupled with unpredictable climate shifts, puts substantial strain on the region's water resources. The province relies on 44 primary dams, currently averaging 66.6% capacity. Fortunately, with the approaching rainy season, dam levels are expected to replenish. Past years saw severe water scarcity during the 2015 and 2017 winter seasons due to inadequate rainfall. It's crucial for everyone to remain vigilant and conserve water to ensure sustainability in the face of ongoing challenges. Well, we love a good sunrise view, and boy, did we receive a beautiful one from Naresh in Kabega. It looks like a screensaver. Naresh, thank you for this. And if you would love to share yours, do so on our WhatsApp line. Our number is 063-408-8863. But for now, let's take another look at your temperatures. What a view.
Wow.
And perhaps you had a dream of those lucky numbers because now you get to play Lotto. Lotto plus one and Lotto plus two for 25 million
wow.
rand in total estimated jackpots today. That's this Wednesday. And you could become the next big winner.
Oh, and that is a lot of money. So you got to play your Lotto for an estimated 18 million today. Lotto plus one for an estimated 1 million. And then you can throw another 6 million in courtesy of Lotto plus two. And you can get those tickets really simply. You can buy them right now, in fact, today on nationallottery.co.za online. You can go over to their mobile app, which is brilliant. You can use the little drop-down tab in your own cell phone banking or go old school, dial *120*7525# for the US. SSD.
Well, we've got all of those details on Expresso's social media pages, so you can go and check them out there. Make sure you also get yourself in the running to win your share of 25 million rand in total estimated Lotto, Lotto plus one and Lotto plus two jackpots, but you have to play now.
Mm-hmm. You got to put yourself in the running. Likewise, if you want to be joining the incredible celebrities on Tropica Island of Treasure in Zanzibar, you got to put your hand up, yo, and actually enter to be a contestant. And you could be joining Nkobilo Kwezi on the island. And in fact, we're going to find out what it's going to take to get you there on the other side of this break.
Oh, well, perhaps Lamisa's desserts will get you there because she is going to show us her hazelnut and chocolate dessert cup recipe. Ooh. So you do not want to miss out on that. We'll be right back.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back. And we're back into the kitchen with another installment of the Culinary Hotline Bling!
Ding, ding, ding!
We have a beautiful mango and passion fruit chiffon cake done. And Lamise is still with us. And Lamise, what are we making now?
Now we are making a hazelnut chocolate dessert cup.
All the tempting things. This looks, not a lot of ingredients, which
no,
I'm happy about.
It's very simple.
Okay, cool. So, what do we start?
Everything you basically have in your kitchen.
Can I buy the cupcakes?
Yes.
Look at me just looking for hacks. Okay, yes. But yes, then it really becomes easy because we're using the cupcakes to create
the base.
The base. Okay. Yes. Let's swap because I know that I'm going to be working on the base. So I've got our beautiful chocolate cupcakes, chocolate chip, sugar. Mm. Okay. So how are we going to
work with it? Just chop it up.
Chop, chop.
Chop, chop.
Okay.
And then we just put it into our.
I'm gonna do, like, I feel like just chop chop.
That's it. That's
okay.
It.
That's it. And then to the bottom of the base.
That's it.
And how much are we looking for? Are we gonna compact
like
it?
Yeah, like half a. Yeah, we can, or you can just leave it like that.
Perfect.
Depends on
I
how
like that.
You want.
Just like that, nice and rustic.
Yes.
Okay. And then the filling. What goes into the filling that we're making?
Okay, so our filling is basically cream, a hazelnut spread, and a little bit of icing sugar.
That's yes. It.
Yeah. So it's like a hazelnut mousse.
Absolutely. Yeah. I'm thinking, like, not just for Eid. Like, this is a nice little thing if you get, like,
a weekend or bride.
I was going to say a sweet craving before.
Because we make it pretty with the flowers and we make it extra fancy with topping some lint balls on top.
Oh, yes. You know? Okay.
So I'm going to do our filling. So first I'm going to add our icing sugar to our cream, which you've already whipped, and then our hazelnut spread.
Thank you for saying I already whipped it. I did not. Someone else did, but did a good job. Tell me about on Eid itself, on the day.
Yeah.
What's the day like in your house?
Whew, it's quite busy. So usually I'm obviously first you have some breakfast, you know, lots of pies in the oven and you know nice fruit platter, something simple, and then because we have a big lunch.
Okay.
So, yeah, we don't want to have too much to at breakfast. And then
When you say big lunch, are you talking a lot of people or a lot of food?
A lot of food.
Okay.
And a lot of people.
Okay.
Yeah.
And like, you're not making everything, because you've got to leave some stuff for the aunties that have their signature items. So what are some of the signature items that always feature on the table?
Okay, so you have to have the leg of lamb, and you have to have a curry.
Uh-huh.
And obviously a biryani or an akni. And obviously some prawns. And then obviously when it comes to the sweet stuff, that's my department. So my mom does the cooking and I'll do all the sweet stuff. So it's obviously a trifle. You gotta have a trifle. You gotta have a baked cheesecake.
Uh-huh.
You have to have a pavlova.
A pavlova? Okay.
Yes, yeah.
But is it a lot of pressure?
Obviously some, we have to have a mousse. And you know?
Because it's you, is it a lot of pressure like this is gonna be the best dessert spread.
I do feel
of
a bit of pressure. Yeah.
But you deliver every year.
I do.
You do. Okay, okay, I've got crumbs. That's chef's treat. I'm gonna come over here.
Okay.
Because I'm gonna toast some nuts for you, right? And that's the hazelnuts.
Yes, that's right.
Let me come back
and
to
then
my.
We're also gonna top it with a ganache. The mousse is gonna be topped with a ganache, which we've just heated. The cream. So it's just warm cream. On top of some chocolate. And then we'll just give it let it sit for a little bit.
And I've got some hazelnuts, right? Hazelnuts. Yes. They've just been chopped. So I'm going to
toast these. And so you're just going to toast them just to give it that extra goodness.
Nuttiness and extra crunch. I love
that.
Okay. So this is the part where you don't walk away at home.
No.
Because nuts burn very quickly because of the oil's inside them. I also keep my nuts in the fridge now.
Okay.
Because of the fact that it's oil-based, like there's oil in the nuts. I don't want the oils to go rancid. I just keep everything in the fridge. And I found that the nuts actually last a lot longer.
Okay.
Okay,
that's
cool.
A good tip.
And it's smelling nutty. This is such a simple recipe. And the mousse that comes together so quickly.
Yes, it does. Okay.
All right, we're almost there.
We just need our ganache.
And this is another one you can make ahead of time?
Yep.
Absolutely. And you could do a big one.
You could.
Okay.
Big one or mini ones, whatever you prefer.
Waiting for these nuts to toast.
Okay, so then we just top it with the ganache. Like that.
I know that you're the goddess of baking in the family and for South Africa. When it comes to savory foods, who handles that?
My mom.
And at home?
Oh, no, I cook too.
Yeah. But I mean, I'm imagining you're equally as talented when it comes to savory food.
Yeah, I can basically cook anything. I think it's just genetics, you know?
There we go. And when it comes to savory food, I'm asking all the savory questions. I'm sure you get all the dessert questions.
I'm very hungry today.
You know. Okay, when it comes to savory food, what's your go-to? What's your absolute must? What's something that doesn't matter what diet you're on? When you see it, crayfish curry.
Or prawn curry. Anything with crayfish and prawns.
And again, like you said, that's something that you can execute perfectly?
No.
No?
No. Not
so
crayfish
whose job
curry.
Is that?
That's my mom. My mom has to do that.
I love a crayfish curry.
Yeah, I know. She has to do that.
Okay. So we're getting some. These nuts do not want to toast. What's up?
No, they're
I know, it's so
fine.
Weird. Okay, we're going to leave them. We're going to keep an eye on it. There we go. But this is looking amazing. And
but we need them now.
Yeah, we do? Okay. Let's do it. Let's pretend the nuts are looking toasty.
Yeah, and they're nice and brown.
Can I pop it in that bowl for you?
Okay. Let's go.
There we go. Okay.
They smell nice and roasted.
They do.
So then we just top a little bit of the nuts just to give it that nice extra crunch.
If you did the workout Graham Richards did this morning, he was stepping like, oh!
Yeah, I think Graham can eat this now with no guilt.
He can have all four the weather that man was stepping this morning.
And then we just top it with a little bit of fresh cream. And a little bit of, still a bit warm. But then we'll add
the ganache. And so the ganache, you will at home let it cool down before you start.
Yes, obviously.
But add that layer, which will preserve your cream. Yeah. I don't know. I got a thing about hot and cold. I think it's going to be delicious. I would sacrifice aesthetics for flavor. Young Graham, step into the kitchen. Can we give Graham a hand?
Thank you. That's my perfect lead-in. When you sacrifice aesthetics. For flavor. Then I know. Okay, it's my turn.
I've actually got a spoon for G in this drawer.
Got one.
He has a special
spoon. I don't know what aesthetics you've sacrificed, but I'm not seeing any sacrifice here. These look exquisite. Absolutely beautiful.
So
right. Is there a process? Is there like a way
deep,
Just go. Deep. Go. Dig deep within yourself.
So
I'm gonna get some of that.
All the layers.
Ooh, and what are these layers?
So we've got a chocolate cake base. Mm-hmm. And then we've got a hazelnut mousse, a chocolate ganache, and a fresh cream topping.
I can't take any of the credit. It wasn't
me. And some hazelnuts.
And some toasted hazelnuts.
Yeah.
Oh!
As an afterthought, that is, it sings. And there is a lot going on there. So there, I think the danger of that being overwhelming or too much, but it hits it perfectly.
Yay.
Wow.
At home, when you make this, hide one of these away, and then when all the guests have gone home, and it's about 11 o'clock at night, you whip this bad boy out, and you sit on the couch,
and
you just enjoy it. Oh, this is such a delicious dessert. Again, go and get this recipe on espressoshow.com. Lamise isn't going anywhere. What's our last recipe?
Our last recipe is a strawberry spiced cookie cheesecake.
Sounds delicious. Yeah. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Oh, G-Man, how was that?
Really good.
I love how they make us eat and then we have a lot of talking to do. Are you okay?
I've got the energy. I've got the energy for
it. Well, you can take a sip.
I've got the energy to go to an island right now.
Yes, because Tropica Island of Treasure, it is back, and the celebrities, they are getting ready for the challenges ahead. And the best part is, you stand a chance to audition to join them in Zanzibar.
Mm-hmm, and win your $500,000, let's not forget. So in between her paddle points at Club Paddle in Pirates in Greenside, an old stomping ground of mine, celebrity contestant Nkobile Kwezi spoke to us about who she is and why you should be her partner on this season of Tropica Island of Treasure. Let's find out a little bit more.
My name is Nkobile Kwezi. I am a sports presenter, a content creator, a model, the baddest on the block, the funniest in the streets, you know, the vibes. What made me want to participate in Tropica Island of Treasure for me had to be the fact that it's so challenging. It's you being put on an island to figure this thing out, and there's a big treasure at the end of it. And I also love Tropica, that's just a sidebar. I'm bringing just the humor. I just want to be the pillar of humor. Just to remember that this is also like a game and it's fun. And a partner, I have to say, I'm looking for strength. I want somebody strong. And when I say strong, guys, strong is different. It's like you've got to actually be just fit. Like, we can run, we can keep this going, and mental strength. My message to my potential partner would have to be, let's go get them. When I'm getting there, I'm expecting blue waters, white sand, sunshine, challenges in the sand everywhere. Join me on Tropica Island of Treasure in Zanzibar, and you can win your share of R1 million in cash. All you have to do is upload your audition video and make sure that you tag @MyTropica and #Tropica, and you can be my partner.
Sure, that's quite a list. Okay,
yes.
Strong mentally, strong physically. I think you got this, and she looks like she is going to be a lot of fun to partner with. And that is the bottom line. You could be joining Nkobile on Tropica's Island of Treasure. You've just got to get your audition tape in. We want you to submit your audition video to social media using #Tropica and @MyTropica as the handle, and you can upload that audition video online, or you can just go old school, send it directly, tropicaauditions@gmail.com.
Remember, the 7 lucky contestants will be granted R10,000 courtesy of Deep Heat before even getting to Zanzibar. Now, this is your chance to be in the running to win your share of R1 million. Now, that's smooth.
Mm-hmm. And you have up until the 5th of May to get that submission in. So work on your audition and just do it, man. Take that leap of faith and enter. All those T's and C's apply, but this could be your opportunity, yes, to win a lot of money, but also put yourself out there. Put yourself on the map on an island in Zanzibar. Come on. Love it.
We're in Zanzibar for Tropica Island of Treasure. Are you... Did you just swim here from South Africa? There's an easier way to find fame and your share of a smooth R1 million fortune. Simply upload your audition to social media, explain why you're a match for our celebs. Add the #Tropica and tag @MyTropica, and we could see you in Zanzibar. Buy a Tropica now and enter to be on the island.
Now, if you thought I was excited to be here with you this morning, Milan has been just bursting at the seams to perform. We've had fun with him, we've chatted to him, we've caught up with him. We're going to let him do what he does best, and that's plug into you, bring the emotion, and have a whole lot of fun with a brilliant performance after this. Then our Eid celebrations continue. We're going to whip up a cheesecake that's got a little bit of a spin, some spicy cookies involved, a little bit of fruit. It looks, and I'm sure, tastes exquisite. Stick around for that.
It's my feel-good
breakfast show. Oh, on a Wednesday, it's very difficult to put our finger on what the best part of the show is. We've been loving celebrating Eid and, of course, all the deliciousness that's going to be going onto the tables, courtesy of Lamise. She's just absolutely genius. But we need a bit of music, I think, to elevate the emotion.
Definitely. And he says he's all about that feel-good vibes. He wants you to take a moment and just enjoy and smile every single day. Ladies and gentlemen, here's Milan, and he's going to explain to us exactly what he's about to play.
Good morning, South Africa. So this song is called Day One. It's very close to my heart. For the longest time, I felt that, you know, I couldn't follow my dreams. No one tells you when you're a kid, yes, you can be a rock star. They tell you, doctor, lawyer, engineer. And so I did that for a few years. I did study engineering at Stellenbosch, but I knew the whole time I had a passion in my heart. I had something that I love, that I want to give to people, I want to share. And so this is a song about following your dreams and really jumping for it. It's called Day One. Please enjoy.
So take it from the edge, from the outside of those walls you call your head. Make it, yeah, make believe, oh, that everything you dream you can achieve. Because I don't ever wanna walk away, I don't ever wanna
rather day one. Whoa, oh, oh, I don't ever wanna walk away. I don't ever wanna stop and say one day, rather day one. So take it round the edge, round the outside of those walls you call your head. Make it your make believe, or that everything you dream you can achieve. So take it from the edge, from the outside of those walls you call your head. Because I don't ever want to walk away, I don't ever want to stop and say one day, rather day one. Stop and say one day, rather day one.
Thank you. So this next song is called Breathe. Please enjoy. You heard it a little bit earlier if you weren't here. It is about getting in touch with yourself, remembering that nature is good for you, that you can always step back, relax, and breathe. Thank you so much. If you haven't seen it, go check the music video out now on YouTube.
I say breathe, let go, the writing's on the wall and all of us know nothing at all. Breathe, let go, the writing's on the wall and all of us know nothing at all. The moon has done it all, the stars sing lullabies. Take my heart and take my mind, love in every way. That's what we're gonna start today. Cause I say breathe, let go, the writing's on the wall and all of us know nothing at all. Breathe, let go, the writing's on the wall and all of us know nothing at all. Except for love, love, love. Write it all in paradise. Take the truth and bring the light. We will love till our dying days. That's what we're gonna start today. Cause I say breathe, let go, the writing's on the wall and all of us know nothing at all. Breathe, let go, the writing's on the wall and all of us know nothing at all. Except for love, love, love. Write it all in fairy tales. Yes, this is the holy grail. We will love till our dying days. That's what we're gonna start today. Cause I say breathe, let go, the writing's on the wall and all of us know nothing at all. Breathe, let go, the writing's on the wall and all of us know nothing at all. Because we're free, let go, the writing's on the wall.
let go. The writing's on the wall and all of us know nothing at all.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Oh man, we are just complaining that we eat too much, we celebrate food too much, but we love it. What else are we gonna do when we've got Lamise in the house? And if you've got questions, trust me, it's been a while since she has been stumped. Let's see if we can stump her on the show today. The culinary hotline is here. We are waiting for your questions, or at least Clem and Lamise are waiting for your questions, especially ahead of a beautiful Eid table. It's absolutely looking exquisite. We're gonna have a little bit of fun with that. Then we're gonna get into all of the fun that was had at Car in Car, one of the most, I think, beautiful celebrations of culture, of togetherness, of connection, and of course the arts, unlike any other. We'll get into those highlights after this.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Back in the kitchen with our final recipe for the culinary hotline bling.
Ting, ting, ting.
Now, this morning we've seen two stellar, ultra-delicious desserts already come out of the kitchen, and now we're making another Eid essential, a cheesecake. And Lamise, you're going to talk me through this. This looks amazing. But once again, not a lot of ingredients happening.
Yeah, and no baking involved once again.
Nice, nice. Okay, so we've got...
So it's a fridge cheesecake.
It's a fridge cheesecake.
Yeah.
And the thing is, people can get very iffy about, like, baked versus fridge, and they go, that's not a cheesecake. It's the same name, two different things. Love them both.
Love them both.
Absolutely. Especially when you get that sweet craving and need it, like, soon.
Yeah.
This is a good one. Yeah, so we've got our base happening already.
Yes.
What did you use for our base?
This is a spiced cookie. So we're just going to, we crumbled it up, and then we're going to add some butter.
But you can kind of use whatever biscuit you want for this pot, right?
Yeah, you can. You can just use normal tennis biscuits if you don't have any, you know, of those cookies on hand.
Okay, and then all you're doing is adding malted butter until it looks like wet sea sand, beach sand. And then I feel sorry for the guys in Joburg. What does that look like? just play sand, like wet play sand. There we go. Okay, so
what we're going to do today, we're going to make a crescent moon shape just to represent Eid, you know. And it's really simple. All you need is your spring foam tin, and you're going to take just a small bowl. You're gonna place it along the side of the bowl.
But don't start yet.
Oh.
I've got a question. Okay, so spring foam tins, right? Two pots.
Yeah.
It's your base and it's the pot that holds it all together.
Yes.
What do we call that? I don't know. So, okay, I don't know why I have two here. Anyway.
Okay.
There's a lip. So what I say, the base kind of looks like a saucer, either that has a lip or it's got the flat bottom like this. How do you put your base into a springform tin? Like a saucer with a lip
up? I know.
I'm asking you because you're the professional. Well, what works for you?
Do you know what I actually do is I usually just put it on the tray that I'm using because what you want to do... So I don't even... You don't need to use the base because... You're gonna take this off anyway,
okay.
And then it's already on the tray.
So it makes it so easier for you.
Yeah.
Actually, yes, absolutely. Yeah. And when you do bake a cake, what is your preferred way of putting the base in?
Oh, well, if I do, then I would rather do it this way.
The flat side.
The flat side. Yeah.
Okay, good to know. Obviously, my thinking...
that's for a baked one, obviously.
That's for a baked one. Obviously, my thinking is when it's baked, it's a little bit of a lip. You have to work with the lip to get it off.
Yes.
So always go upside down for a baked cake.
And it's flat.
Because I do see people doing it both ways, and I'm like confused. What is the correct way? And according to me, your way, whatever you do, is going to be the...
Do you like that way?
I love your way. I love your way. Now I broke it.
No,
it's fine.
Well,
it's fine. We don't even need this anymore. Now I understand why there were two.
Not if we're doing the fridge.
I'm sorry. Okay, so base in, and then you've got a little cup that just basically fits in to create that shape.
Just to create a crescent shape, and then we're going to just pop this in.
Not so quiet because I was focusing so heavily. Okay, perfect. That's amazing.
Yeah.
So what it does, I'm gonna give an example of what it actually does. I'm fast forwarding now. Let me get this out the way. So the bowl goes in.
Yep.
And you put the base in, and we're gonna still work on the filling, but it gives you the crescent shape. That is amazing. Okay, cool. Base done. Now let's start talking about our filling.
Right. So our filling is just cream cheese, icing sugar, and whipped cream.
Okay.
And a little bit of vanilla extract.
So
or vanilla essence if you have, and then we're gonna chop up some strawberries, if you don't mind doing that.
That's me. That's me.
Yes.
So I like
get busy on this.
We've had Graham in the kitchen already for a little taste test.
Yes.
I'm always trying to stay in people's good books in the studio because I actually catch on a lot of nonsense. So I'm going to call our floor director, Lucian Albertini, in a minute.
Oh,
so
you can
go and get mic'd up because man loves coming to the kitchen. And he'll
and
act
he loves
shy.
To eat. He'll
be like, stop calling me to the kitchen. And then he'll pose. So, Lucian, if you can get mic'd us along, I'm going to let you come into the kitchen.
We love calling me inside.
I do. If you guys haven't seen Lucian's episode of making cupcakes last week, go and check it out on YouTube. Stellar. If we don't win a SAFTA for that, done. Okay, so Lucian, talk to me about desserts. Do you have a sweet tooth?
Yes, I do.
I'm
more of a savory person than sweet fingers in the sweet tooth, so. But I'm enjoying this.
So, are you more of a fruit, when it comes to desserts, are you more fruit based? Would you go for our chiffon? Or are you more like chocolate type?
Chocolate. Type?
So, you would have gone for our second dessert, which
is I already stole Graham's.
Leftovers.
We don't have germs in the TV world, so we just share each other's stuff. Mm-hmm. There we go. Okay, so Lucian, we're busy making a fridge set cheesecake for you now.
I didn't notice.
You didn't notice? Okay, well, that's what we're doing. And we're topping it with strawberries. Did I do a good job? You want them halved? Okay,
yeah,
I've got some more for you. So we've got some strawberries for you. What I want to do is I want you to actually taste the... I want you to taste our chocolate dessert because you said you like chocolate so much. But now, the people didn't see, Lucian. The people didn't see it, it never happened.
Okay.
So I'm going to get you a spoon. Here we go. Come stand on the corner. And I want you to give us your most detailed breakdown of the dish. Okay, go. Flavors, textures, what are you feeling?
Wow. Okay.
So pretend you haven't tasted it yet. Oh, the producer's saying, can you please play that music? Let's see if we can get... And he says he's shy.
Another one.
Okay, so Lucia, talk to me. So what you've got now, we've got that chocolate base, the chocolate...
My mother's watching now.
Mrs. Albertine, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. So, we've got the chocolate base, okay? Chocolate mousse. Chocolate ganache.
Hazelnut mousse.
Cream. And then we've got the lip ball on top. Okay, so talk to me about the flavors. Because you saw us make this on TV, and this came together like in record time.
Well, the cream, the chocolate, the nuts, and everything that comes together in the mousse.
Mm-hmm.
It's an explosion. It's so, so good. And I will... You know what? I'm taking the whole thing.
You take the whole thing. It's a win. Where can people get the recipe?
The recipe on expensishow.com.
You know. Lucian Albertine, can we give Lucian a hand? Because he's shy. Thank you, Lucian. You have your golden spoon, you have your mic, and you have your chocolate. You deserve it. Have
I'm
a
out,
lovely
I'm
day,
out.
Lucian. Okay, so while Lucian was doing that cake, the cheesecake came together. So strawberries go on top.
Strawberries go on top, and then you also just sprinkle some of your spicy cookies on top, just to give it that extra crunch as well.
And I see we've got caramel. Does that go on the top of
No, this is our spicy spread.
Ooh.
So then we're going to add another layer of the cheesecake mixture. Okay. And then we're going to pop that in the fridge to set overnight.
And please do set it overnight. The texture changes so much when you do set a fridge cheesecake overnight compared to when you rush it. This one can still go to the fridge for a little bit longer. I can see it's a little bit wobbly, but we're going to use our imagination.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Okay. We're going to pretend. Anyway. We're going to pretend. So you've got the spiced sauce.
Yes. A spicy sauce. So basically, stick your spatula.
And then this will also remove our bowl.
Just to loosen it. Yes.
Let me get you a lappy. It's coming. A lappy is coming. Here we go. Napkins.
Got a napkin over here.
This looks so delicious. Ooh. Yes. Yes.
So.
And now the bowl comes out.
And then the bowl comes out.
Please don't
out.
Serve it with the bowl in the thing. Just saying. Okay. Oh, look at that.
And then we're just going to smooth it out a little bit.
This looks so good.
And then we basically take our spicy spread.
Tell us about the spicy spread.
It's like flavors of cinnamon and caramel.
Let me grab a spoon real quick. And then, so do you make that from scratch?
No, you can buy it at the store.
Oh, okay, that's pretty cool. Look at me not knowing where, my tasting spoon.
Oh, we'll okay. put in the recipe, which spread it is.
Wow, sugar, That tastes so good. It tastes toasty and spicy, nutty, and it's in my mouth now, like peanut butter. It does taste really good. They're making fun of my tasting spoon, Lemmies.
What? No, I love it.
When chefs taste with like a little teaspoon, what are you tasting? What are you tasting? No.
Yes, no, you need a big
This spoon. Is the espresso official tasting spoon. Done. Okay.
Okay.
Lemmies, that caramel, biscuity, nutty, spicy sauce is so delicious.
Okay. Oh, okay.
You know what? Blame it on Carl Waste. He's not even here. It's his fault.
Oh, my goodness. Okay. Our spread is not spreading as nicely as I would have
And that's why
liked.
At home, please do make sure you set your cheesecake overnight.
Yeah.
You know what, Lemmies? I am going to get into this with one tasting spoon. It is going to be so good. Oh, my goodness. I do think we should do is also slice into our chiffon. Should we do it?
No, you have to. See all those beautiful layers.
Okay, let me get it. Ooh. Yes. Okay, I'm going to start taking off and getting ready for this. Please don't forget to take off your blue bow.
Your little ribbon. Okay, let me cut the drawer.
Please, can you actually cut it? I don't want to like destroy this beautiful creation.
Sure.
It is so beautiful.
Okay, do we have a plate?
I'm going to just use this for a second. Oh, here we go. I'm actually going to put the whole slice on here. Oh!
Okay. I can get it out.
My goodness.
Here we go.
You definitely came back on. Tasting spoon.
Nice.
Tasting spoon is back. Okay.
Oh, wow, that's a big spoon.
I'm going to invite whoever, Graham, Zoe, if you're nearby, come to the kitchen, but make sure you grab a spoon when you come in the drawer on the far end. Who's here? Where you come? Graham and Zoe, please make your way to the kitchen. That is so light. The lightness is the first thing that you get.
Yeah.
And then the flavour, the passion fruit, the acidity is just right.
Yeah.
It is so delicious.
It mixes well with the creamy, the sweet cream.
Let me invite the usual suspects into the kitchen.
Yes.
Graham Richards. Sorry, Brian, did you have your spoons?
See, we're not going to sacrifice the aesthetics this time, my friend. I brought along a special friend.
Whenever Lemmies is in studio and she bakes for us, I understand why her Instagram handle is Just
buddy.
Bake, because it's delicious.
Okay, so let me give you the options.
Show everyone inside.
You're on another planet now. That was quite a highly pitched, effeminate little squeaky.
Look here, the sugar. Again, like I said, I haven't seen in the longest time. That was amazing. So Lemmies has made the most amazing, delicious desserts.
Wow.
We have a beautiful chiffon cake, which has got mango and passion fruit in it. We've got a chocolate. Would you say trifle? It's not a trifle.
A cup.
It feels like a dessert cup.
Yeah, but that still undersells it. I'm sorry. It's just delightful.
And then, because we didn't set our cheesecake enough in the fridge, but I tasted elements of it, and it is so amazing. Good, breaking things.
Bam.
So, Zoe, you can absolutely taste whatever you like. G, same for you. You can even go back to the chocolate if you want.
Are we allowed to taste the
cheesecake? Yeah, I'm a lover of cheesecake, and I don't mind that it hasn't set.
I would eat this whole thing.
You need this.
See, I like this vibe of the cheesecake. I like it to be kind of, you know, the fridgy type feel. Yes. Like, that's my vibe. Okay, what side are you going in?
I'm
going
to go here on this corner. There's something about the crust.
Yeah. Absolutely. Let's get that music going.
No music for me.
I can't have the music anymore.
Graham goes first.
Okay, Graham.
And luckily, Linz just knows me to be a complete fool, so it's okay.
Oh. Don't zoom too much, you need to see his hips. Oh my goodness.
You earned it. You earned it. All those steps you put in this morning.
Wow.
No, but you gotta try this one.
Here we go.
Slow down.
We're just gonna make you dance today, Graham.
Oh my word.
This one's my fave.
It's the balance. It's the balance that I don't have when I dance, that you do have when you create flavors. Okay, again, now you make it impossible to take the first bite because there is just so much.
So you need to take the biggest mouthful, I think that's all everyone.
And then we'll go into an ad break. We'll finish with you. How's that?
Did it look that big when I kind of put my spoon in there?
You got
meringue. I've got to do it, eh? I've got to do it.
Go for it.
Come on.
Give him the music.
We can do this, man.
Again.
Oh. Really? No. Stop. No. Okay. We can do this. Together, we can do anything.
Now tell everyone we're going to an ad break and we'll be right back.
Oh no, it gets steamy.
Didn't you get our April Fools? We do actually express ourselves through interpretational dance. That's what we do, man. That's how we run the show. Okay, here's the thing. It might have felt like a TV bite or looked like it, but the second it goes into your mouth, everything just melts together. Yeah. Absolutely exquisite. Wow. Mm.
Oh, listen, we will be right back. Lamise, thank you so much for joining us today. It's always a treat having you here. And we've got more delicious recipes still on its way. But if you want to get any of these recipes, it will be available at expressoshow.com.
Claim said.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Which camera are we looking at?
Welcome back from stage production, some of the best in the land, to some hilarious stand-up comedy, to dance performances, to kids entertainment, visual arts, some incredible talks, mentorship, and a whole lot more. The renowned 2024 Car in Car Festival, sponsored by ABSA, was the place to be for the best of local arts and culture, a deep dive. And here to share some of the incredible highlights from an action-packed week, plus is the regional segment head for private wealth, banking from Absa, Yolisa Mlungwana. Yolisa, thank you so much for being here.
Good morning.
Looking at me nervously like we're going to feed you cake this morning. We might. We might just do it when we've got food that delicious. I love it. But I would imagine you are spent. Whether it's delicious food, whether it's taking in incredible plays and productions, learning about culture, this festival bears no comparison. What was 2024 like?
Listen, Graham, I think 2024 was probably the best it's been in a very long time.
Well done.
I attend the festival relatively religiously, but for 2024, it was jam-packed. I think the festival goers had an experience this year round, from shows, from productions, to stand-up comedy, to live shows, to stand-up concerts on a daily basis. On top of that, there's fashion. All of the vendors you get to spend. So if you go to the festival, make sure that your pockets are full.
For sure. That's,
definitely.
That's why you're there, yo. That's why you're there. Yo, exactly.
We also have a whole range of things that are arranged. We also have something called the Kea Kamer. It's an Absa lounge. If you know Oturen, you'll know how high the temperatures can get. It's a yes. lovely space where festival goers can get to relax. They can get to cool off, listen to some interviews, listen to some live shows as well, and really get the experience of the festival throughout. There's kids entertainment. It's a very family-orientated festival. So you really get to experience everything festival-related.
I think, if anything, you're maybe a little spoiled for choice, because there are some, you could do a deep dive just on the plays, just on the musical performances, just get there for one of those magical talks. What I love about this is the layers to this. When we talk about the growth of culture, it has to start at the base. And when you involve young children, I understand you did something miraculous, something amazing with 500 young'uns that I would imagine got a completely different experience. Tell us more.
So the lovely thing about the festival is that it touches all age groups, young ones, families, old people, I think all genders as well. So what we got to do is we really got to sit down and have some talks with regards to some of the kids. We spoke a lot about culture. We spoke about stories. We got to get some of APSA's staff members, some of industry experts as well, to talk to the young ones just about stories around how to craft your future, some lessons that you can learn, arts and culture in general, and just the deepness of the festival as well, and just how crafting your story and your journey really talks to how you arm yourself for the future and how you really get to navigate life in general. It was lovely to see. It was lapped up by all of the attendees.
Brilliant.
And they really, really enjoyed it. And it's something that we actually want to grow on a year-on-year basis, because it's very impactful. And we feel that it's something that's really going to arm the youth with skills to be able to attack life.
Can I tell you why? Because your story matters.
Matters, 100%.
Because it does. Yes. At the end of this incredible journey, you're going to look back and you're going to want to see that narrative. You're going to want to see your legacy, your impact. We forget that that has to start somewhere, with a vision, with the power, the tools to be able to do that. How does this align with what you're wanting to do as an organization, as a bank, who believes in those individual stories of the big and the small who are yet to find their big? How did this align so well?
So our reimagined brand ethos is Your Story Matters, as you would have recently seen in the media. And it's really being about people-centered. It's really being about community-centered, the communities that we operate in. And we feel that our involvement in the festival really talks to our community. It talks to how we want to get involved in the communities that we operate in. And it talks to, obviously, just being people-centered. We are a very people-centered organization in general. And our involvement in the festival and in the community of Oturen in general really talks to that, and it aligns perfectly in terms of what we are trying to do. In the festival throughout, we spend a lot of time on people's stories, entrepreneurs' stories, where they come from, how they grew, and every single story in that town, every single story of every single person who attended that festival really matters.
It does matter, and that's why you put your money where your mouth
100%.
Is.
100%.
And I love that. Our stories collectively are our culture. And how we tell our culture is through our arts.
100%.
Why is this so important? You've made this one of your pillars. Why arts and culture?
Arts and culture is universal. It really combines people. You'll understand that it's an Afrikaans festival, and I attended an Afrikaans festival. I attended some of the stand-up shows, some of the comedy shows, and the arts are universal. They unite people. They are not really, there's no language barrier around it, and you really get to enjoy the essence of the core of the message, regardless in what language it's delivered in. And that's why we are involved in it, purely because it's universal, it unites, and really is about communities and the deep, deep history of the Afrikaans culture.
Oh, I think more of your company are going to be wanting to go religiously after hearing that glowing report. Thank you so much. I know it's an investment in the small businesses, those professionals, the people who are coming through those ranks as well. But it's a much bigger picture investment as well. So thank you for being the custodians of arts and culture in this way, because it really does matter as well. Your story matters, 100%. In fact.
Thank you.
We know, we have proven how much impact telling a story in the right way can have. And if you missed out on this year's Car Kind Car, don't worry, we have got you covered. There is always next year, and it's probably going to be even better. But definitely make it a priority to get out and support local artists, stage productions, dancers, vendors, any kind of performance, any way that you can plug in, do it. Your engagement keeps our artistic community thriving and ensures a vibrant cultural scene for generations to come, because their story is probably the most important of all.
There are stories of strivers, and we're inspired by them all. We invite you to write your story with us. Your story matters. ABSA.
It's a few minutes after eight. Let's take a final look at your national headlines. While South Africa's economy continues to face challenges such as load shedding and impaired port and logistical operations, the South African Revenue Services, SARS, has collected a gross tax revenue of 2.155 trillion rand for the 2023-24 financial year. SARS Commissioner Edward Kiswetter said this amount was in line with the revised estimate, representing a year-on-year growth of 4.2%. It exceeds the revised estimate set by the Minister of Finance, Enoch Godongwana, by some 10 billion rand and represents a year-on-year growth of 3.2% for 54.2 billion rand more than last year. And the Pretoria High Court has ruled that there are no legal grounds preventing law enforcement officers from carrying out their statutory duties. Judge Sulet Porteril said this yesterday in her ruling on the Speaker of the National Assembly, Nosisiwe Mapisa Nqakula's application for an urgent interdict against her arrest. Porteril dismissed the application with costs. Another urgent application by the Speaker for a permanent interdict against her arrest will be heard on Tuesday. Mapisa Nqakula is suspected of corruption and money laundering during her tenure as Minister of Defence. We move to news beyond our own borders. Famous Nigerian music star Davido has instructed his lawyers to sue over an April Fool's joke that spectacularly backfired. The prankster's story alleged that the Afrobeat singer had been arrested in Kenya after cocaine was discovered on his private jet. The 31-year-old megastar, who has just completed an East African tour, said the fake report was extremely irresponsible. Such was the backlash that Kenya's Directorate of Criminal Investigations tweeted a screen grab of the TV headline with fake news stamped across it at mid-morning on Monday. Israel faces growing international pressure over an airstrike which killed seven aid workers of the charity World Central Kitchen in Gaza. Nationals of the UK, Poland, Australia, Canada and the US died in the attack. Humanitarian aid to Gaza is now in doubt as World Central Kitchen, one of the main providers of aid to the Strip, has suspended its operations. UK Prime Minister Rishi Sunak has described the situation in Gaza as increasingly intolerable and demand a thorough and transparent independent investigation into the death of the seven aid workers. Bringing it back home, the South African Foundation for the Conservation of Coastal Birds, SANCOB, in Gqeberha has achieved international certification from the Global Humane Conservation Programme, a significant milestone in its mission to protect seabird populations. Global Humane, renowned as the world's largest certifier of animal welfare practices, bestowed this honour after SANCOB passed a rigorous independent assessment. Dr. Robin Gunzard, Global Humane's president, praised SANCOB for its exceptional animal care, particularly its efforts in reversing the decline of endangered species such as the African penguin. SANCOB's Gqeberha Centre manager Carl Havman said they were immensely proud to have met Global Humane's high standards and would continue to provide the highest quality care to their seabird patients. Well, that is where I leave those headlines. Here's a final look at your sport.
Thank you so much. So let's start with rugby, and quite an emotional one, as Sam Whitelock, the most capped player in All Blacks history, is now officially set to retire from professional rugby at the conclusion of the current club season in France. So the 35-year-old talisman, who plays at lock, obviously, for 153 appearances, in fact, for New Zealand, an incredible achievement. And of course, securing two Rugby World Cup titles in that process during his illustrious career. But following New Zealand's narrow defeat at the hands of the Boks in the last World Cup final last year, Whitelock now joined Pau in France's top 14 on a two-year contract. And his retirement announcement now dispels any speculation about a potential return to Test rugby this year, amid rumours that the new All Blacks head coach, Scott Robinson, I'm sure played with him at one point, had approached him, but his time is done. An incredible career there. Now we turn to cricket, and sadly, Ben Stokes is out for England. The all-rounder has made the decision to officially withdraw himself from consideration even for this summer's T20 World Cup, and that to prioritise his fitness. So following knee surgery during the winter, Stokes only bowled just five overs in the recent five-test series in India. And the 32-year-old, who also serves as England's test captain, previously opted out of the IPL as well. And that commenced obviously last month. And England, the defending champions, will compete in the T20 World Cup, scheduled to take place in the beautiful West Indies and United States in June. Now let's look at the cricket currently unfolding at the moment, and it's explosive. Quinton de Kock's impressive half-century, then Mayank Yadav's outstanding bowling performance backing him up, propelled the Lucknow Super Giants to a commanding 28-run victory over the Royal Challengers Bangalore that was in their IPL encounter at the M. Chinnaswamy Stadium yesterday. So opting to bat first after winning the toss, clearly the right choice. Lucknow Super Giants posted a formidable 181 for 5 in response to the Challengers. They struggled to get going. They were bowled out for 153 in just under 20 overs, falling short of that target. Now we can get excited about golf once again, as the 2024 Masters Tournament is set to commence at the Augusta National from the 11th of April to the 15th, featuring a select group of LIV Golf members now vying for the prestigious green jacket as well. So Augusta National, renowned as one of the most iconic and, I'm sure, difficult golf courses worldwide, hosts this highly anticipated event, marking the beginning of the new major season. And among the LIV players competing, Sergio Garcia, Dustin Johnson, Phil Mickelson, and Brooks Koepka. So a very strong field, adding some excitement to the tournament. Meanwhile, Tiger Woods, he's in the headlines once again. He could break a tournament record by making the cut for the 24th consecutive time, that in his incredible 26th appearance at the Masters. So hopefully he does just that. But that's where we leave our sports for this morning. The roads should be up and running properly by now. Let's get you to work safely and then touch on the weather.
Thank you, Graham. Let's start off with traffic in Sandton, Johannesburg. There's heavy congestion being experienced at Winnie Mandela Drive, with the back of queue at Malebongwe Drive. Expect delays and allow for more travel time. That's your traffic. Let's take a final look at your weather. And the SA Weather Service has not issued any severe weather alerts for today, although scattered showers and thunderstorms are anticipated in various regions, accompanied by cool to warm temperatures across most of South Africa. Meanwhile, Johannesburg Water anticipated completing repairs at the Honeydew Reservoir by early this morning. The reservoir had been experiencing capacity issues, causing water shortages for residents in Randburg and nearby areas during the Easter weekend. Johannesburg Water assured residents of continued support, including alternative water supply through mobile water trucks at unit until supply is restored. Well, that is your weather news. Let's take a final look at your sunrise view. This was sent in by Chris from Bloemfontein. You can see quite a bit of cloud cover, but yes, the sun is peeking through. If you would love to be like Chris and share your morning view with us, do so on our WhatsApp line. That number is 063-408-8863. Here's a final look at your temperatures this Wednesday. Thank you.
Well, it's under 30 degrees in Upington. It must be a change of season. Maybe your season is about to change if you play Lotto, Lotto Plus One and Lotto Plus Two for an estimated 25 million rand in total estimated jackpots this Wednesday. Oh, you could become the next big winner, a super millionaire, but you've got to play. So you can play Lotto for an estimated 18 million, Lotto Plus for an estimated 1 million rand, and then Lotto Plus Two is adding a further 6 million rand to that, and you can buy your tickets really easily. There are so many ways. NationalLottery.co.za online. Go to their mobile app. You can use your own cell phone banking app. You can simply dial *120 *7529 hash for USSD. We'll keep all of those details up on our social media platforms, so you've got no excuses. Go and check them out and think of those lucky numbers. Just make sure you do it. Put yourself in the running to win an incredible 25 million rand in total estimated jackpots between Lotto, Lotto Plus One and Lotto Plus Two jackpots today. But you just gotta play, so good luck. Go and do that right now. Maybe you can think of those lucky numbers as we enjoy the final stanza of the show. We're going to be having a lot of fun getting into the new season. Obviously, some new autumn and winter trends in the homeware space to delve into. Some gorgeous new trends that we'll tap into. Then Milan is back for another performance to hit you right in the feels. We love this kid and he is here just for you. Stick around.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Now let's get you inspired about the space around you. And as the leaves change colour and the temperatures begin to drop, it's time to welcome a new season that paves the way for some beautiful emerging trends. And with Woolies' new AW24 homeware collection, we can sit back and truly embrace the quiet luxury that winter has to offer. It's about comfort coupled with the absolute beautiful enjoyment of the space. And here to give us a glimpse into the season ahead is senior homeware designer from Woolworths, Courtney Lowe. Courtney, thank you for bringing such beautiful gifts this morning. No, I know we don't get to keep it, but we get to access all of it. And I am loving the earthy feel. I feel more grounded just looking at these colours. And this is the energy we want in our space. So welcome back to the show. Great to have you here. I suppose a great jumping off point would be with some of those dominant trends, the big ones that have got you guys excited. What's going to be guiding us as we shop our way into autumn and winter?
Well, really the two biggest themes and looks we've created for autumn-winter 24. The first is for our autumn part of the season, so it'll be now in the next few months. It's called Artisan. So really it's inspired by nature and things made by hand. So that's kind of the look that we're trying to create. We've paired like rich red tones with earthy greens and all the naturals, and just to try and bring about a bit of grounding in one's home and calm sophistication. And the second half, so high winter, we are inspired by the feeling of nostalgia.
For sure.
And so we look to simpler times to be inspired for print and pattern and for colour as well. So our nostalgia range will be for our high winter period, and it's like rich inky teals, shades of brown and ochre. So that'll be coming later, but what's in stores now and what I've brought here to show you today is Artisan.
And I love it. It's bringing a little bit of the outside in, but there is such a focus on comfort. Everything that you've spoken about, even some of the warmer colours as we move into that winter space, even the idea of nostalgia says cozy comfort. It's about creating that energy
Absolutely.
In your space. When you use words like Artisan, though, when you look at these, almost it feels like individual design elements that are offered in every individual piece. You are enabling trendsetters, and that's
Absolutely.
On both sides of this equation here, whether it's those incredible artists creating for you or those of us wanting to set those trends in our own home. But how do you get that right? How do you enable the thought leaders, the trendsetters?
Well, what I selected to bring here today is actually items that can refresh your home and just one or two items that can really make you look like you're on trend for the season. And a great way to do that is like through vases and vessels. So the selection of vases and vessels in various shapes here is perfect if you've got an empty shelf or surface top that you're just wanting to refresh. And of course the vases can either be displayed as like an accent piece or with some dried botanicals.
Or functional.
Fresh flowers, faux flowers. So I think that's really like a key item for the beginning of the season, just for a little home refresh.
And what I like about this is you can push the boat out a little bit and try different things. If you get a couple of staple pieces, because they can stand alone as just a design element,
yes.
or they can be incorporated into a beautiful, broader look and feel. I mean, I'm looking at a table chock full of individual pieces that all blend together beautifully. The stylistic
yes.
choices, the colour, absolutely exquisite. I love the ceramic end, that finish on the ceramic.
Yes.
Beautiful. Should we go and explore the dining room?
Yes.
Ooh, wow. I love it. The layers here, but that succinct overall look, absolutely beautiful. Talk us through some of the highlights here.
So as you know, we've got quite a festive period of time coming up now.
Yeah.
I think as people gather around with their families and celebrate food, I thought we'd do a beautiful table setting.
And these are investment pieces. These
Absolutely.
Are stunning. When you take them out, the table setting alone would be a talking point. So talk us through these pieces.
Okay. Sure. So this beautiful digitally printed ceramic over here is called Karoo, and it's really just inspired by Fynbos. And it adds a little design detail. The placemat that it's on is black, but it's got a frayed edge, which gives that crafted look of Artisan. These table runners here go in the center of your table, so you can just literally buy that one item and refresh the whole table. You can have it without a tablecloth.
So, I mean, with the wood, it works beautifully.
It really does.
If you've got a natural stain, that's exquisite.
And they have this crafted Artisan look about them, so
For
that's
sure.
also what's inspired the trend. And then this is our clay range, which is made in Portugal. It is, I feel the weight on that.
Oh, that
it's super authentic
lovely.
Stoneware. And then again over here, we've got this napkin. Napkins are a great way to just buy one item and refresh or create a little statement. This is a photographic print of Fynbos,
oh,
which is
wow.
beautiful. And just, you can either tie it up, you can fold it neatly on your table setting, and that's one item that's a pick-up price point that can really transform your table.
I'm picking up some beautiful fragrances hitting me.
So our latest range over here, you can see, is our Hort Room Diffuser. It comes in a room diffuser. It also comes in candles, quite big and small. It is beautiful. It's very nostalgic. There's some spicy hints and a little bit of fruitiness.
It's the way that it all blends together that is mind-blowing for me. Every single element works within the broader scheme, but they stand alone as either a little stylistic element, a showstopper, a conversation starter, as you say, a refresher for that space. Courtney, I've got to say that you do make it easy to work with these pieces on the board. Like, I can understand how we embrace the trend, but we want to get practical. This is not just a showroom. It's not just a show house. We want to live in it every day. We want to feel it. We ultimately want to get the most out of our homeware and our decor. What tips, advice maybe do you have for those of us wanting to embrace these trends this winter?
Autumn winter is really quite chilly.
Yeah.
And it's all about creating a softness. So I've shown you some of the hard items here today, so the ceramics and the dinnerware. But in your home and when you cocoon and relax, you really want cushions and blankets that you can just cuddle up in. So I think our push for this winter is winter warmth, and we have got the most beautiful range of faux fur cushions with a matching blanket, and just draping that over your couch or sofa or your bed can really add that touch of warmth into your home as you walk into the room.
I love the fact that you've made this accessible, so thank you for that, that you can get some beautiful, really striking design elements that are very accessible. They are all investment pieces.
Absolutely.
A little goes a very long way. I feel warm, I feel cozy, I feel invigorated, which is not often how we feel going into autumn and winter, but with these designs and the room to play, I feel so excited about embracing the new season. Thank you so much. Your team has knocked it out the park this season.
Thank you.
Oh, we love it. We love creating the ultimate comfort zone this autumn and winter in our own spaces with Woolworths Home. They have really gone all out, and you can shop these trends, their latest AW24 collection, in-store, online, or you can use the app to get some inspo and plug right in. Courtney, thank you so much. I'm actually looking forward to autumn and winter this year, which is saying a lot, but the stuff is exquisite.
Thank you. Thanks for having me on the show.
Oh, thank you, G-Man. Getting us so excited to really bring in those beautiful autumn and winter tones into our home. But we promised you more music, and we have Milan on your Feel Good Breakfast show.
Woo! Good morning, South Africa. Here's my third song for you. This one is called Happy and Grateful. And this sums up why I became a musician, is to spread positivity in the world and, yeah, to uplift people. This song, Happy and Grateful, sums up every single other song I have, basically. So if you only have to listen to one, listen to this one.
Without further ado, let's go. If you got a smile on your dial, it'll only take a little while. If you got a smile on your dial, it'll only take a little while to spread it. If you got a smile on your dial, ever bothering you, can't forget it. Yeah, if you got a smile on your dial, it'll only take a little, fake it till you make it. 'Cause you gotta be happy and grateful for the food upon your table, the body that's willing and able, the love in your children's fables. I'ma be happy and grateful for everything around me, friends and all my lovers. I'm talking sisters and my brothers. People often ask me, is there order in the madness? Yes. Ask me, is there love built into service? A way that I can earn this? Is there a way that I can earn this? Yes. 'Cause you gotta be happy and grateful for the food upon your table, for your body that's willing and able, loving your children's fables. I'ma be happy and grateful for everything around me, friends and all my lovers. I'm talking sisters and my brothers. Happy and grateful for the food upon my table, for my body that's willing and able,
love my children's fables. I'ma be happy and grateful for everything around me, friends and all my lovers, sisters and my brothers. Happy, I'ma be up on a star, a wish. Happy, I'ma be up on a star, a wish for you wherever you are. Happy, I'ma be up on a star, a wish for you wherever you are. To conquer your demons and always keep dreaming in the power of love. Cause I'ma be happy and grateful for the food upon my table, for my body that's willing and able. Love my children's fables. I'ma be happy and grateful for everything around me, friends and all my lovers. I'm talking sisters and my brothers. Yeah, I'ma be happy, I'ma be a gangster, spiritual poet, and I thank you for always believing and never stop dreaming in the power of love. Yeah, happy, I'ma be up on a star, a wish wherever you are, to conquer your demons and always keep dreaming in the power of love. Yeah, happy and grateful for the food upon my table, for my body that's willing and able. Love my children's fables. I'ma be happy and grateful for everything around me, friends and all my lovers. I'm talking sisters and my brothers. Happy, I'ma be up on a star, a wish wherever you are, to conquer your demons and always keep dreaming in the power of love. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Love you guys.
Stand a chance to win your share of 40,000 Rand worth of prizes with the exceptional plush range of household cleaning, leather and shoe care products.
Oh yeah, now to enter, purchase any of the plush ranges, take a photo of you using the products and WhatsApp the picture to 069-201-5794.
And with up to 30% off plush products at major retailers this Easter, what are you waiting for?
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back as we dive into the world of entertainment, what our favourite stars have been getting up to, some of our favourite celebs, and they have been busy and we love catching up. So I'm going to dive right in with a man who I think when he first launched his career was literally on every page, newspaper, back page that existed.
He's stepped away a little bit. He's produced some incredible films since then, but we are wanting to know what's going on behind the scenes. So we plug into Robert Pattinson and then, of course, actress and singer-songwriter Suki Waterhouse. And they have now welcomed their first child into the world together. They were spotted walking together in Los Angeles in March with Robert pushing a beautiful pastel pink pram between the two of them, looking oh so celeb in the way that they do it. And the couple have been together since, they've been dating since 2018, and they are speculated to have gotten engaged following Suki's baby bump reveal. You might have seen that as she was performing at a music festival in November, and I described or decided to wear something particularly sparkly because I thought it might distract from something else that's going on. And obviously they're talking about the little baby bump that was very much evident. Cannot be sure if it's working. I don't know if it did because the whole internet just about broke when we saw it, but we love it. Congratulations to both of them.
Oh, definitely. Well, South African musician Tandiswa Mazwai gave an outstanding performance during her Tiny Desk appearance, which was released on Monday. Her first song was dedicated to the beautiful and ever-resilient people of South Africa. Her performance was part of the Tiny Desk and Global Fest series, founded in 2021 to promote international music discovery. Now, she is one of the most influential musicians of post-apartheid South Africa, and for almost 30 years, she has championed a form of music called Kwaito. Her song, Children of the Soil, is set to feature on her upcoming album, Sankofa, which is dropping in May, and the first single from her upcoming album, Kulungile, featuring Nduduzo Makati, will also be released on the 12th of April.
Oh man, I can remember the Bongo Muffin days. Man, I was there when they first broke the mold. I'm glad to hear the word Kwaito again in these Amapiano years. I absolutely love that. Well, we love the past and we love the present and we love the future when it comes to our arts. And the South African film Real Estate Sisters, which screened earlier this month at the Joburg Film Festival with much aplomb, was written, produced and directed by Ria Betswe, Moweti Vocht, and Zoe Ramushu. Remember those names. They are going places. This dynamic duo hope to inspire other Black female filmmakers, producers, directors, those in the industry to go and pursue their dreams. And it was produced in partnership, incredibly, with South Africa's National Film and Video Foundation, the NFVF. That's what it's there for. And the Department of Trade and Industry, in conjunction with the South African Consulate General in New York. Rightly the right kind of partners, the New York Film Academy as well. And then, of course, the Empire State Building. It's an incredible comedy that's set in Pretoria and stars these two incredible actresses, Gina Kaufman and Lera Mtetwe, as the sisters move, obviously, house, and they are selling with an incredible chemistry and hilarity. And Jen Su had the opportunity to plug into that at the actual Empire State Building.
Good morning and a very warm welcome to Espresso. I'm Jen Su and here I am with Rhea and also Zoe. They have the Real Estate Sisters. They are the Real Estate Sisters. And they're going to be premiering their film. I can't wait.
Hi Jen, we're really happy to be here in New York and excited to premiere our film in the Big Apple. It's a really big deal for us and we're really excited and grateful for the warm welcome we've received from the South African Consulate in New York, from the Empire State Building, from New York Film Academy.
Tonight we will be launching our film Real Estate Sisters, which is based in our capital city, Pretoria. It's about two ladies, two sisters who are really trying to break through into the real estate industry. And as you know, it can be so challenging for two young Black women. So we really want to tell their stories and represent where they're from and the flavor they bring to the screen. So we're really happy to have worked with Gina Kaufman and Lera Mtetwa, who really personify what those girls are about.
Amazing. And do you have a final message for your fans and friends in South Africa?
Absolutely. I think the final message that we have is that anything is possible, your dreams are valid, and don't think small at any point. Like, all things are possible. And Africa to the world, right?
Yes. We're very proud to be here. We're proud to represent people who look like us, who want to be where we are. Absolutely, keep pushing, keep hustling. You can get anywhere you want to be.
We are ready for action. Champagne?
Check.
Yes. Chicken wings?
Check.
This is Waterkloof Ridge, you know, the Sandton of Pretoria. It's very spinny.
I found a dead man, a dead body in the cellar of the fridge of the house that we are selling.
Stay where you are. Don't move. We've got a search warrant for this property.
I love it, real estate sisters. And I bet you right now there are two young South African women that are about to go do that in New York and smash and own the game. But we love it. So well done. We love seeing those kind of collaborations come to bear, especially when there is a South African connection like that.
And keeping with the South African connection, the prestigious South African Style Awards illuminated the halls of the Sandton Hotel in Johannesburg, reaffirming its status as a cornerstone event on the South African social calendar.
And with this year's theme, centered around opulent shades of gold. Oh, man, in the city of gold, nonetheless, celebrities showed their interpretation of this radiant mode. I absolutely love the mode. Now, Harmony, of course, was there, I'm sure, with a little bit of gold on to experience. Let's take a look.
The South African Style Awards celebrate individuals who in their own respective career fields are disrupting the ordinary creative course of business. Remember, the Style Awards are not just about your fancy clothes, but also about your accomplishments. So today we are here at the beautiful At Sandton Hotel, hosting the 26th installment of the South African Style Awards, brought to you by Plascon. The 2024 South African Style Awards is brought to you by Plascon. And I've got Patty here. Why is the 2024 South African Style Awards in collaboration with Plascon such a match made in heaven?
Plascon is the leading paint company, proudly South African, and we are celebrating proudly South African style. And it's wonderful to see the beautiful golden colors that have come up. We are the leading in color as well. It's just amazing to see all of that.
But I want to know, from Plascon's side, what are you looking forward to seeing tonight?
Amazing style, amazing personalities. And obviously, it's important to celebrate people. It's important to celebrate work that they've put in and everything that they've done as South Africa. And that's why we're here as Plascon as well, because we care about the people and we're here to celebrate that legacy.
Ellen, this is going to be your 13th year hosting the South African Style Awards. How are you feeling?
Well, you know, SA Style Awards, it's another year, another set of great, stylish, wonderful winners. I think this award represents people that are trailblazers in the industries that they own, be it fashion, be it design, be it media, be it the iconic role that, for example, Dr. John Carney plays. For years, we've been celebrating South Africa and South Africans. And this is another one that we're going to add to the books. And of course, great sponsors. Plascon's back on board this year, and very, very proudly, this is powered by Plascon, because of course, besides being a part of people's color and design to the walls you see around you all over the city and your home, but also it's about supporting South African and local, just lekker.
Style, fashion, swagger, drip, whatever you call it, it's right here at the SA Style Awards. The atmosphere is so charged because all the stars have descended here. We're seeing Bonang, we're seeing Tyler being celebrated, we're seeing Dr. John Carney. Oh, it's just phenomenal. Let's continue having fun. So tell me, how do you guys feel about today?
What we are grateful for is that they called the family on the stage. Unfortunately, Tyler couldn't be here, but extremely excited, extremely honored to be here on behalf of our sister. And we're just the proudest family.
How does it feel, you know, being at the Style Awards?
I mean, it's surreal, you know. The fact that she even won an award in the SA Style Awards, so it's actually surreal. And again, we're so proud of Tyler.
I'm here with one of South Africa's style icons and one of the individuals who has won today. How do you feel? You've just won an award here at the South African Style Awards. How are you feeling?
Man, I'm still trying to process the whole thing, you know. I mean, it's such an honor, actually. You know, I've been winning awards internationally, but like, this is home. It means like it hits different, you know, and I'm such honored. I'm still excited right now, you know, yeah.
won for the SA Style Awards 2023 as the next big thing, it was a life-changing moment for me. And I think it was just such a great recognition to be awarded for something that I also love as a content creator. Last year, I got people who were clapping for me. So this year, I am here to clap for them. So that's what I'm excited for.
I'm really looking forward to seeing industry friends. And I think that, yes, of course, there's the awards and the personalities, but there's this beautiful golden thread that flows through our industry. And it's these moments that bring us together again. So for that, I would be most grateful.
I think the most thing I'm looking forward to is seeing the style, seeing how we're going to keep things fresh, and just to mingle and meet my colleagues and peers.
What does it mean to celebrate? I think it just means that all your hard work has paid off. If people honor you, if people recognize you, if people cheer you on, and if people really like you every time they meet you, they're smiling from ear to ear. I mean, that's already an answer enough to say that you've done well over the years and you're still doing well. So just to see the joy in people's faces when they see you, when they make whatever comment they may make and greet you.
It's the style icon himself. How are you doing, Dr. John Kani?
Well, I'm walking on cloud nine. This is really an honor for me. It really makes my heart feel so good. I wish our awards was as organized and glamorous in the whole evening's event like the SA Style Awards. The whole organization of the Style Awards, SA Style Awards, they valued the people they honor, and they gave them the respect that they believe that these people deserve. Yeah. And therefore they gave them an event and an evening, a celebration befitting their status.
This has been an evening that we won't forget anytime soon. Congratulations to all the winners, so deserving. And also a huge thank you to SA Style Awards and PlasCon South Africa for acknowledging all these incredible individuals who inspire change and innovation.
Oh, and certainly did they look stylish.
Absolutely beautiful. Congratulations to everyone who won. We know it's not just about how you present yourself. It's the wake of advancements, of innovation, of cultural development, growth. However, that wake behind you looks, it's the way that you impact the country around you that earned you that nod. So congratulations to everybody.
When the cracks start to show, our strength and resilience is legendary. Microtex, strong enough to endure anything.
The beauty of modern medicine is the ability for precision and targeted intervention, and also for greater opportunity of better health outcomes. Today, we dive into the sphere of systemic inflammation. And here to give us expert advice is the CEO of the Medical Nutritional Institute, Marianne Duplessis, and also the researcher from MNI, Ashley Smith. How are you doing? So I want to find out, today we're diving into systemic inflammation. inflammation, a condition that is linked with a lot of our modern diseases today. Can you tell us a little bit more about it?
At M&R, we focus on the metabolic syndrome. And just as a quick reminder, the metabolic syndrome consists out of five components. One is linked to being overweight. Two components are linked to abnormal cholesterol. The third one is abnormal glucose levels. And the fifth one is high blood pressure. Now, systemic inflammation is considered to be the link between these components. And that's why we at M&R see this condition as a targeted condition that needs early intervention.
It's so interesting that there's so much linked to it. But can you tell us what causes it? Where does it come from?
In short, systemic inflammation is inflammation that is not limited to a specific area in the body. So that means it can be caused in different organs or systems in your body. Now, acute systemic inflammation can be caused by various factors like infection or trauma. So once eliminated, your body heals quite quickly from that inflammation. But we have to remember lifestyle factors like being overweight, high cholesterol, bad sleeping habits, uncontrolled glucose levels, bad eating lifestyle, you know, it all causes systemic damage to our bodies. And that then activates inflammation. And that's where the problem is, because it's over a long period of time, and then it becomes chronic systemic inflammation.
Actually, what are the health risks associated with systemic inflammation?
So extensive medical research has shown that the damage caused by systemic inflammation plays a key role in the development of various chronic conditions, including type 2 diabetes, obesity, insulin resistance, cardiovascular disease, neurological diseases, as well as various forms of cancer. And so early intervention and managing your inflammation is vital for optimum health.
And M&I is obviously on top of this. So what are your solutions to it?
So M&I supports an anti-inflammatory lifestyle with the Cape Meal Plan that we've specifically developed and our various exercise programs, both of which are available for free on our website at mnilifestyle.co.za. And then you need to support your body further than this. FlamLee from M&I fights acute and systemic inflammation and protects your body against the various inflammatory disease conditions. FlamLee's unique blend of ingredients results in excellent absorption, making it very effective in fighting inflammation, relieving inflammatory pain, and also just protecting your organs from inflammatory damage. The British Arthritis Research Organization has rated the ingredients a 4 out of 5 in terms of effectiveness, and it's actually also grouped into the safest category. Another advantage is that it's gentle on the stomach, and so you can take it daily for an extended period of time. FlamLee is available at all pharmacies, or you can get it online at mnilifestyle.co.za.
Thank you for joining us and shedding some light on some well-needed information. Well, there you have it. Knowing your body will give you the chance to help your body when you need it most.
Thank you, Harmony. Well, it's time for us to be back in the kitchen, and it's time to share uninterrupted moments with family and friends while showing gratitude for everything, even the little things. And still looking for the perfect dessert to celebrate the end of Ramadan. Well, here we are to entice our taste buds with a delicious berry pavlova trifle. It is a baker with Lamise Abrams, who's here to help us with this. And Chef Clem, you are here to also infuse us with the daily difference, all the incredible deals that we have to create this incredible pavlova.
Absolutely.
Well,
Woolies does know, like, this is the time of the year when we get into our sweet treats. So if you're going through the page of the Daily Difference, you'll find absolutely everything you can need for your eat table this Eid. And Lamise, you've done it justice. And it's not even done just yet, but I'm seeing the final version.
Oh,
and
look
it looks
that.
Stunning. What are we making?
So we're making a berry pavlova trifle.
Trifle.
Okay. I mean, do you call that a trifle?
Beautiful.
That is so beautiful.
Ours never look like that whenever we attempt to make it. So, Lamise, what is the secret?
I think patience. Just taking your time, and because, you know, Woolworths has already prepared most of the goodies for you. So it's just assembly.
Just assembling it. Now, we've got our jelly, and have we set it?
That's been set.
Oh, it's got a beautiful jiggle to it.
Yes, and to get those layers of the fruit that looks like it's floating, add one layer of jelly first, and then you let that set, and then you add your raspberries, and then you add another layer of jelly.
Okay.
So it just looks like, so otherwise they sink all to the bottom, so that's just a nice tip to keep it floating.
I now understand why you say you have to be patient with
this. Yeah, just let things sit, and then, you know.
I see that you used the gold glitter on the raspberries. I'm kind of thinking if you put a little bit of that gold shimmer in the actual jelly just to make it extra.
Pop.
Yes.
Oh, I love that. Now, I've got some whipped cream here in front of me. What would you like me to do with it?
So you just add your custard.
Okay, so we are using... Do I add all of it?
I think add half.
Add half. Yeah. So we'll go in with half. That's a guesstimate. A little bit more, we might as well add it all. There we go.
And then just give it a nice
stir. Okay.
And I'm busy with the Swiss rolls.
Yes, so we just cut
those. You're slicing it on the long.
Yeah.
That's most of the effect. And yeah, I love that because we're so used to slicing
the... And you can see the inside as well.
Okay. I love that we're changing up something that is, you know, a lot of South Africans love to make a trifle.
Yes.
But we're changing it up. So I know Chef Clem, we would normally opt to slice our Swiss rolls into little wheels.
But this is a great way because you see that cross section, and again, it's all about the visual
presentation.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Look at me stacking
up. You eat with your eyes first.
You really do.
You do.
Yeah.
And especially trifles, I feel like that's why trifles are presented the way they are in that glass-like, beautiful bowl.
Yes, exactly.
Because you want to see the layers. Or now you want to see the effects that you've got. This has been my job for the day, stacking things up against the side. You know what? And I'm going to get better
at it. And it's tricky.
I'm going to go home. And
you're going to go practice.
Just practice.
Okay. And you want all of the insides to face out so that you can see those different layers. And there, the first one fell over.
Yeah.
It's okay, Clem. We won't hold this against you.
I promise you, I did go to chef school, but we didn't practice.
We didn't practice doing it on TV. That's the problem. There we go.
And then, so Zoe's filling, which is the custard and the cream.
Yeah, that so becomes we're just going to put that in the center.
Oh, this is so beautiful.
So we're not keeping the layers separate because my memory of a trifle is usually your layer of custard, your layer of cream. We've now combined the two.
Yes.
Okay.
Because once you take a scoop,
they get combined anyway.
Exactly. You get all those layers.
Okay. This is amazing because it actually fills the bowl perfectly with the correct amount of Swiss rolls. We have done it.
We have done it.
Okay. Proud of myself. Is this the filling that Zoe's worked on, or is that something else?
This is the filling I've been working on.
Okay, and I'm wondering if this is the same version of that. Mm. Perfect, we might have extra filling.
Okay. So can I go for it?
Yes.
This is pressure. So all of the filling just goes into the middle.
Yes.
I'm going to get scooping so we don't waste.
My favorite thing about your recipes today is everything can be made ahead of time and actually should be made ahead of time, which means come the day when you have all your guests arriving.
Very time saving.
You're looking easy, you're looking fresh.
You can look
you're
gorgeous, not, and so will your cakes.
Oh, that looks so good.
Beautiful filling.
So, we've already whipped up our meringues, and basically, we're just going to spoon them onto our parchment paper and then place them into the oven on 110 degrees for like an hour. And they should be nice and golden brown and crispy, just like those ones.
Oh, lovely.
And then you just get to have fun. We get to decorate the top of our beautiful trifle. I see we have some, are these almonds? Or,
yes.
Okay, we've got some.
The chocolate-covered almonds.
Chocolate-covered almonds.
And we have some raspberries, which we dusted with some gold dust and some meringue kisses. So you can basically just
play around
and top it however you feel.
Okay. We've seen Lamise decorate three cakes today. Do you want to try it and you're going to decorate this?
I feel like Lamise is just filling up the to make sure you want that layer of Swiss roll to be covered, right?
Yes.
Okay, so you want to be generous with your toppings. To find this ultimate berry puffalova trifle recipe, you can head on over to woolworths.co.za as Lamise shows us how incredible easily it is. I love how easy she makes it look, and then you attempt it yourself, and you're like, oh, what's happening here?
No, it's going to be easy, I promise.
Oh, it's all about the various elements and bringing it all together. Yes. Now, you can celebrate moments that matter with friends and family over delicious halal certified sweets and treats. You can shop everything you need for your Eid fest at Woolworths. You can do so in-store, online, as well as on the app. I absolutely love what we did here. Well done, team. I'm just going to finish off with some meringue kisses.
Yes.
There we go.
Perfect.
That's the most beautiful trifle I've ever seen in my life. I don't even know if I can call it a trifle. And if we are going to call it a trifle, that's the new standard.
There we go.
Yes, new standard.
Fantastic.
Love.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back, you beauties. One last message from us. Play Lotto. Lotto plus one and Lotto plus two today. Why? Because there is 25 million rand in total estimated jackpots ready to be taken home by you. You could be the next big winner.
Yes, well, you need to play Lotto for an estimated 18 million rand, Lotto plus one for an estimated 1 million rand, sure, and Lotto plus two for 6 million rand. And you can buy your tickets today in store on the nationallottery.co.za website. You can also buy your tickets on the mobile app through your cell phone banking, or by simply dialing *120*7529# for USSD.
Most importantly, just do it. Any one of those options, all of those options, just go and do it. And we'll keep those options up on our social media pages. Just make sure you get yourself in the running for that 25 million rand in total estimated Lotto, Lotto plus one and Lotto plus two jackpots today. Go and play and good luck.
Oh, well, we've had some incredible performances from Milan. Here he is with final one, and this one is Golden Teacher.
Ooh, 'cause I say bury me down by the way downstream. I'ma take her to the grave if you know what I mean. Thrills ain't cheap and I got to keep you. Never on a date with a golden teacher now. Teacher, teacher, golden teacher. Teacher, teacher, golden teacher. Take me so high I became the preacher. Now bury me down by the way downtown. Take her to the grave, I'ma let it out. Thrills ain't cheap and I got to keep you. Yeah, the devil on a date with a golden teacher now. Teacher, teacher, golden teacher. Teacher, teacher, golden teacher. Take me so high I became the preacher now. Golden teacher now. Thank you. I love you, South Africa. We'll see you on the next one. Much love. Thank you. Goodbye. That is all.
Oh, cheers. We love you, Lamise. Thank you so much. This table has been amazing. Hopefully yours looks just as exquisite. To all of you who are going to be enjoying those Eid feasts, embrace it and enjoy every second.
Yes.
We'll see you tomorrow. Adios, muchachos. Thank you, gang. Welcome.
I'd love another one, please, Mommy. With Bacho and lots of Jack.
Another sandwich.
Clover Bacho. Spread the dairy goodness.
Made with love by Clover.
Another feel-good production.